So.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, you know what it is. It's that Vandal Hour, and I'm DJ Swift. I'm back. I'm back. Yeah, man, I miss y'all, man. I miss all of y'all worldwide. Y'all know how we do it each and every week. Shout out to all
my
followers.
Yo, yo, yo.
Nationally, internationally.
Yo, 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 yo.
Well, we got a great show lined up for you tonight.
Yo, 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 yo.
Yo, yo, yo.
We got the Vandal Hour family in the building. E Sinatra, Facts on Wax, Dre Kills. We got Mathematics in the building. We have a great guest in the building as well and a great co-host. But I'm going to keep that a surprise for y'all. Y'all got to wait and see who it is. But y'all know what I'm here for. I like to play that hip hop. I like to play that good music for you. So I'm about to jump right into what I do and stick with it, what I do. Swizzy. Yeah, that's right, that's that. Flatbush Zombies, man. Nephilim, Nephilim. Vandal Hour, let's get this, y'all.
Why I feel like the past is catching up to my ass. The devil on each shoulder, no halos on my staff. Your medulla may implode when I spit this venom in cold. When I spit this venomous flow, my bending entity, yo. My soul glowing is gold. My heart's dark and it's cold. My art's a part of my soul. I can't help it, get down the most. My dick is big and it's in the back of a coat. Break bread and make toast. Raise glass and blow smoke. Kick ass like burning and mac on with these hoes. Flip packs and bust and live on through these hoes. Too mentally unstable to be fuck around with them labels. Picture me yakety yak talking shit at these round tables. Nah, son, never that. Let's just millies under the table. I'm saving up every cent. Starting our own label. Serpent under the rainbow. The pot of gold and the toll. Falling angels.
The zombies don't recognize borders. If the zombie disease in the United States could easily turn into a continent-wide pandemic,
and drug be the antidepressant and pursue the president. She might have to keep you a Western aim at heads of presidents. That'll make change in a second. Motherfuck your reverend and all the lies that he telling.
They say we not able. Strange, but peek through different angles. Speak the truth, cause what we plant is all seeding for the future. Probably cooler than I thought I was. Parley with a few. I'm hot, bitch. I ain't Nelly. This ain't Nims. I'm something deadly. Petty niggas, y'all ain't ready to shit. I kick is heavy. A felon moving steady. Ungrateful bitches get stitches and buried 6 feet in ditches. In the clouds painting pictures. Sometimes I'm feeling enormous. I'm about to jump, I'm feeling nauseous. Close your eyes for repercussions. Try to use a gun, man, but the gun jam. Maybe if I won it, probably get me. Grab a gun and tell them, put one in my lung. Shoot one through my heart, rip my tongue apart. Never again to speak this art. And I ain't gotta sign a motherfucking deal. I could still fuck your girl off a blunt and some chill. Smoking up them hotels. Put it on my bill. Sleep till next Wednesday. Wake up to her grill. That super stanky dank got me high. Mushroom hills in the event of my demise. I'm laughing at you, rap guys. Spitting lies. Spitting lies. Spitting lies.
Thank you.
TFRadio.com.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Conan. Conan, I'm the man.
I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I'm the man, I'm the man now. I was caught up in the struggle, world trap right in the bubble. Baby.
Here we go.
Just be my buddy, just suck me and suck me. I might so just cuddle with you. Jacuzzi and rose, ooh ooh. I done been on tour, man. I done been in places. I done been on stages where the crowd look outrageous. Catch me in Miami dropping panties like it's Nathan. Wallin' with my family and family, it's Eddie Kingston. Penny, there's plenty of what you chasing. Shorty, tell your man, I'm the man that's out there hating. You working resume is a statement. I'm always high, sometimes I smoke with Jamaicans. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Barry Life featuring Corey Guns. Copacetic. Understand what we doing. COD, Barry Life. Cleaner, dirty.
For with you, it's the fountain of life.
My flow's like coke and coke cans at the coke. Lead the fiends copacetic on the coast of the notes. Flow's like coke and coke cans at the coke. Lead the fiends copacetic on the coast of the notes. Flow's like coke and coke. Flows like coke, coke cans at the flows like coke, flows like coke, flows like flows like flows like flows like coke and coke cans at the coke. Lead the beans cope aesthetic over kosher notion. My bad, bad mind. I stroke, I stitch deeper, I make a vo-vo curse at me. Those just words at me. I'm so that bitch throw her purse at me. Cash, cash, see me through that back route. Two-seater diva, she a freak. Always catch her with that. I medicate your ex, brains on my step.
Yeah, that's right. This is how we do it in DTF, baby.
I keep the birds flocking. My
we all a factor. We all make noise.
Let's rewind that back.
Follow us on that Ustream. Follow us on that Ustream.
Whether fiction or fact.
Follow our Instagram. Follow our Twitter.
We got the booth in the trap house blacked out. 40 on a four-wheeler, whole hood packed out. We got the booth in the trap house blacked out. 40 on a four-wheeler, whole hood packed out. We got the booth in the trap house blacked out. 40 on a four-wheeler, whole hood packed out. Most of that booth is just mapped out. We got this wrong shit mapped out. My mind is full of iodine. I define the lines, blowing loud, ain't no quiet time. My mind is full of iodine. My mind is full of iodine. My mind is full of iodine. I define the lines, blowing loud, ain't no quiet time. Very life, we bout to make the city pop. Shotty in the black trench and watch a nigga. My mind is full of iodine. I define the lines, blowing loud, ain't no quiet time. Buried life, we bout to midi the city pop. Shotty in the black trench and watch a nitty-bitty pom-poms. Niggas, dawn slippers and twirl twisters. And niggas, sass, bless, holy water, charm. The hard liquor dissolve, it's all in her. She gone, lost, she tossed, lost, split her.
My garments is exquisite, so being in my presence is a privilege. Don't forget it, I lick the shot and watch you dissolve. And as the barrel tip burn, use your bitch tongue to cool it off.
We got the booth in the trap house blacked out. 40 on a four-wheeler, whole hood packed out. Most of that piff on this crate just maxed out. We got this Bronx shit mapped out.
Live the buried life. Listen, Ryan Reynolds, you can live the buried life. Used to drink when I lived the cherry life. With my nigga Ellis when I used to live the Perry life. I want the pie, heavy slice. Kill your whole family on Christmas in a merry life.
Yeah, that's right. Got the 30. If you feeling what we hearing,
Madam X.
Do remember we got June 15th popping on. One,
you all get the guns.
Hashtag New New York.
Wait till y'all get the sun. My whole life I've been in the Bronx with the grunge. I could die happy now cause I belong with the pun. I used to smoke loud, too strong for my lungs. Now I'm addicted to pussy, bark for my lunch. I rap doing my pull-ups, bar just for fun. More than half of these niggas that rap won't touch a gun.
We got the booth in the trap house blacked out. 40 on a four-wheeler, whole
Yeah.
Hear that piff on this crate just max.
Do remember, follow us on that Ustream, DTF Radio. We lit in the building, baby. We lit in the building. I can't wait for y'all to see our guests right now, man. Oh, man. Right about now.
Hey, yo. Peace, Vandals. It's your motherfucking boy, Facts on Wax. And right now, you listening to the Vandal Hour live on DTFRadio.com. I state facts. I will never lie to you. Make sure you tune in each and every Saturday from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. You can also catch us live on our TuneIn app. You can also catch us live on our DTF Radio Ustream page. But remember, you got to do that when we on live. I state facts. Hey, yo. For the people who don't know and they want to learn more about the Vandal Hour right now or after the show, you could go to YouTube and put DTF Radio or DTF Radio or the Vandal Hour in our search engine. When you just see that icon and logo, click that. That should'll take you to history. I state facts. It'll take you to the Vandal Hour. That should'll take you to the Vandal Hour on scene. And yeah, it's a lot of big things popping on the Vandal Hour on scene. I state facts. I will never lie to you. Now, for the people who don't know and for the people who do know, we got a website which is called www.thevandalhour.com or www.thevandalhour.net. We got an online store. We got behind-the-scenes pics and more. I state facts, but right now that shit under construction. But when our construction work is finished building what they building, that shit will be epic. I state facts. Hey, yo, comrade, what's poppin'? How you feeling? How was your week?
I'm good. Peace. I'm good. A lot of plans changed to Summer Jam tomorrow. You know, we heading out there with my people to Summer Jam.
Oh, that's tomorrow?
Yeah, yes, the weather's playing a crazy fucking messed up part in that.
I'm saying, so Mother Nature ain't getting no dick, so she acting up.
We had to switch the plans up last minute, you heard? Shout out to my man. I gotta give him a shout out. SYS football team, Mel. He's the one who put him and his peoples put all this together, and they invited me. It's about 20 of us.
Okay.
We're going out there tomorrow. So shout out to SYS, Sell Your Soul football team. Shout out to the Rays, formerly from Williamsburg. They doing anything out there in Williamsburg in that rough two-hand league. Shout out to them. Other than that, man, I'm trying to get this week over. A lot of busy things coming up. A lot of traveling for the Vandal Hour in the next. Next few months is going to be going on. So.
I heard we going to Cali or some shit like that. So.
Yeah. I didn't even know we was going to even be talking about that. But yeah, we definitely going out to California.
We're taking
a team out there.
We're taking a trip to our Cali in August.
Two shows.
Two venues. We're going to be out there for 3 days. We're going to have, I believe it's going to be one of the spots, the Lexington in downtown LA.
Mm-hmm.
And I forgot the other name of the other spots, but we're going to be doing, it's going to be called a JF, from JFK to
LAX.
Our show featuring New York artists and California artists together. It's going to be crazy, man. It's going to be crazy. We're bringing a whole team down there. And we're gonna thug it out down there, man.
I've been dying to get out to Cali, man. I've been dying to get out of there. But other than that,
I ain't going front. When you going to Cali, though, I'm getting a vest because I am not trying to get big or Tupac.
Nah, we good. I got the plugs down there. I already hit the peoples up. Oh, shout out to 4130 out there in LA. They gave me the text like,
hey,
hit me up when you're down here. We golden.
Biggie and Pac had the plug and they still got shot. That's a motherfucking fact.
True indeed. It happens everywhere. But other than that, man, what's going on with you, man? How's the week?
Man, my motherfucking week was epic, nigga. I walked in the store. I came back out that motherfucker with 500 copies.
I seen. Oh, and let me say this.
I'm an animal.
You very are much of an animal. The internet is buzzing right now, actually.
The homie went viral, man. Yeah. The homie went viral. So, you know, shout out to them 25,000 in 3 days for him doing what he do, liking that shit and viewing it, man.
I don't always go viral, but when I do, it's never a dull moment. That's why I got this motherfucking hat on. I mean, I went and got a crown. Niggas is on my dick. They trying to hashtag that crown and shit. So now I got this hat. I'm top five dead or alive or one of the motherfucking illest boosters in New York City. If I see y'all niggas running around with this hat, yeah, I'm throwing shots. I'm throwing subs. I'm going in on your nigga. I will never lie to you. But yeah, this motherfucking week has been a motherfucking epic one. I mean, I was so drunk today on my motherfucking way to the Vandal Hour. I fell asleep on the motherfucking A-train and woke up at 40 Deuce. Yeah, my motherfucking day and week was popping to me.
A regular week in Facts and Wax life, y'all. Yeah, I don't know. Listen, y'all, before we get into, well, tonight, let me say this. Tonight, we got a really, really dope show planned for y'all. Tonight, we got a Queens writer in the building. He's been doing this thing for a minute now. His artwork is definitely out the box and
that's
dope.
That's a fact.
He goes by the name Reaps, and he'll be in the building later on chopping it up with us. Also, tonight, we got a dude known for his spitting. He definitely gets his head right. A dude that's definitely lyrical, and he goes by the name F.U., and he'll be chopping it up with the Vandal Hour later on the show. You already know, we give you a lit show every Saturday night. But before we get into anything else, let me introduce the beautiful and intelligent young lady sitting in with us tonight. She is one of the actresses from Money and Violence. She also has a nonprofit organization called Too Real Tea Party. She's an entrepreneur and soon to be radio host. It is my pleasure and the Vandal Hour's pleasure to introduce to you Shot Too Real Peters.
Woo! Hello, hello. Thank you. Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Appreciate you coming out on a busy Saturday night, joining us here. How's your
My
night?
Pleasure.
How's it going so far?
It's going well. I think it'll get even better as the show go along.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, first, let me say welcome to the Vandal Hour here on DTF Radio. Good to have you here. For the viewers and the listeners that are tuned in right now that might not be familiar with you and your work, just give them a little background.
Well, I'm known for my character that I play on Money and Violence. My character's name is Jessica.
Yes.
I also have a nonprofit organization that people are now finding out about. Well, I mean, it's fairly new, so mm-hmm. but I'm getting a lot of recognition for that as well. I was awarded a citation by the Brooklyn Borough President for
cool,
it.
Cool, cool, cool. We let off gunshots for good things.
Don't worry, I'm a little bit used to gunshots.
Okay, there we go. Then you're in the right place. You're in the right place. But that's cool. How's the organization going so far?
It's going well. Every month I have a workshop for the girls. But however, I'm still pending funding.
Okay.
I'm still pending grants. My schedule has become a little hectic. So I have not had a workshop for like the last 2 months. But as soon as the funding start coming in,
of course,
the grants,
of course,
they'll be
setting
back
everything
up and
right
running.
Up.
Yeah.
Oh,
so I'm on
up.
Hiatus with that for a while because I'm doing a lot of other things.
No problem with keeping yourself busy. Good luck with that.
Pardon self. Is it hard finding funding for these situations?
It is. I believe that it is when people are scared to be frauded. You know, they're scared of fraud. They don't want to. So people are cautious where they put their money. But I haven't gotten any bad feedback. You know, I have gotten, you know, some personal loans, things of that nature. But the real money, the paperwork has to be right. You know, lawyers have to be involved and things of that nature.
Absolutely.
And I come out of pocket. You know, every workshop that I have has been out of pocket.
Wow.
You know, so
we commend you. Commend you for doing that.
Thank you. It's hard. It's not easy, but my heart is in it. So.
And what do you do in these workshops?
Well, every month the girls can come to the workshops. They get their hair, their nails done, and
cool.
they get facials.
Cool.
And then that's for the first 2 hours. And
wow,
then the second
popping.
The second 2 hours, I have a guest. So the last workshop, my guest was Terry Woods, the author, mm-hmm. author of True to the Game. And
cool.
Yeah.
Dope.
So she spoke to the girls. So every month is a different theme based on the guest speaker. So the last workshop was setting goals, and she talked to them about, you know, her story, because her story is like out of this world, you know, becoming a millionaire, selling mm-hmm. books out of the trunk of her car.
Sure indeed.
You know, 1 month I had Tatiana Ward, Beat Face Honey. She's a celebrity makeup artist. She did, she was Nicki Minaj makeup artist for okay. a while. I had Nicole Chaplin, which is a fitness instructor. So the girls come and they, you know, they get their hair done. They get pampered. You know, these are girls that are in group homes and foster care. So, you know, when you're at a disadvantage, people tend to wallow in their disadvantage. But I want to put them on the same playing field as people that they go to school with, so yes. they don't feel less, you know.
Out of place. Absolutely.
Right.
That's dope. That's
dope. So they get to come there and get
Well, I hope you get all the funding. And if somebody's listening, cut that check.
Thank you.
Good cause, man.
CTC, cut that check.
You're ready.
Word.
let me ask you this. We spoke about it in the little intro we did for you. You were a part of Money and Violence.
Yes.
You played the character Jessica,
yes.
which was well-connected with one of the main characters in the show, which was Rafe.
Yes.
How was that experience for you, working out with that, with the Money and Violence?
It was a dope experience. I've never really done any acting before Money and Violence. I've only done background work.
Okay.
Acting was never a passion of mine. So, you know, Rafe, I knew him for a long time. So that's how I fell into it. And he knew that it was something that I, in the environment I had experience in. So he asked me. But it was dope. The first thing I've ever done as far as acting was... the flash mob in the movie Friends with Benefits.
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
Friends with Benefits.
I thought I was going to a dance audition. I used to dance. I thought I was going to a dance audition, but it happened to be an audition for that flash mob. When the movie came out, the attention that I got on Facebook was ridiculous. I'm like, maybe it's something I want to do.
There you go.
But I was never passionate about it. But, you know, he knew that that was something that I did, so he asked me to do the show, and, it's changed my life in some ways. So the experience is really dope. Being on set was really dope. It was a dope experience.
Well, we definitely watched the show.
Definitely.
Me and my executive producer, we be in the crib watching the show. And out of everything, you know, great show from beginning to end. Great show. But the last episode, which was crazy. Now, a lot of people might not. We were watching this, so you could vouch for this. We was in the crib watching this.
And what was crazy is when it happened, I kind of like walked away for a second, and their reaction was like, yo. I'm like, rewind it. What happened? And I had to watch that like 100 times.
And obviously, we're talking about the part when Jessica and Rafe have that bad mm-hmm. situation. Mm-hmm. Now, what shocked us about it was because you played such a soft and smooth, caring character. Like, I guess it's called Money and Violence. A lot of violence in the show. But I guess that was one we was just like, wow.
The juxtaposition of your character in that scene was very... crazy, because it's like two opposites. A violent thing is happening to a person who's not that. Mm-hmm. So it was a great juxtaposition that he did with that scene. Mm-hmm. I believe.
I mean, what I usually say in response to that is that in life, good things happen to bad people and bad things happen
yes.
to good people.
Very true.
Life is not fair. It's
I
not.
Agree.
I hate when people use the term "that's not fair." My response is always, "Life is not fair.
It never will
Nothing
be.
Is
Absolutely.
Fair."
Absolutely.
I don't believe in anything being fair, because it's not.
Mm. Hey, yo, Too Real, what's popping? For when I did some discovery work, I heard you got a drink you're working on. What's that about? Talk to the people.
Yes, I do have a drink company coming out with two partners of mine. It's called The Fun House.
Okay.
That'll be launching sometime next month.
Oh, is this an alcoholic drink? I'm just
yes.
being curious.
All right. Yes, it is.
Okay.
It's mixed drinks. They're very pretty, and they are good.
Okay.
Like the owner?
Yeah.
Fun
like
house.
Like the owners.
Okay.
It's three of us.
Okay.
I only met one.
You met two, actually. One of them is here.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Okay.
All right.
Aside from drinks, we'll also be doing edibles.
Very nice.
It's that trippy treat.
We are definitely familiar with that side of the game.
That's a fun house.
Yo, it's crazy because that's like, I came to DTF under that premise. The show, I started doing the show because I came here as a guest. And I was selling edibles, man. And my edibles, I was like making like $5,000 a month.
Yeah,
man.
Our edibles are so good.
Fun house.
I will be copping those.
Yeah, you definitely get a few orders from us here at the Vandal Hour.
We are 420 friendly here.
Super friendly.
We will be doing catering, and we will also be having our own fun house parties.
Whoa.
Okay. Nice.
We definitely will be in those. You also are working on a movie, if I'm not mistaken, 99 Problems. You're working on something now?
Yes. Working on a movie, 99 Problems, an independent film. It's a comedy.
Okay.
Okay.
It's very funny.
I love to laugh. There's nothing wrong with that.
It has a lot of funny actors in it also. We have Tyrone on the...
Yeah, to get out of here. Instagram, Tyrone?
Yeah.
Oh, wife. Wow. That's dope.
We have Loki Mar.
Okay.
Shiggy. the guy that always plays the music at the end of his
yeah, I know you're talking about the slow music.
Yeah, him.
Funny dude.
Julito from The Wire.
Okay.
Mark John Jeffries.
Dope.
Strong Lil C's.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a dope
strong
cast.
Man.
I got a question to ask since the show is called 99 Problems. Do y'all got Jay-Z even though he got 100 now?
Nah, I don't think Jay-Z is in the budget.
You never know.
That's dope. When do you know, like, around when could we be expecting something about it?
I have no idea.
All right, work in progress. So pay attention, y'all. 99 Problems. She gave you a sneak peek into the cast, which sounds like a great cast.
Yeah, a
comedy
cast.
Joint. And we'll definitely be looking out for it as well. And you spoke about the Two Real Tea Party and the organization going on. You took a little hiatus. You'll be back with that. So make sure y'all show love and y'all support. We have her information on our page, so you can go check out the Instagram. I think the Instagram is also at Two Real Tea Party as well, right?
For the organization.
Yeah,
for the Rails Tea Party. Yeah.
Yeah, so make sure you go over there and you show some love and you support for a good cause, man. Now, of course, you're also involved or going to be involved in a new radio show.
Yes.
From her versus him.
Her versus him. Yes.
Tell us a little bit, as much as you can, about that.
Her versus him is going to be a radio show. I mean, the name says what it is. My co-host is a male, and we just battle it out.
Uh-oh.
Like, you know, guys have their way of thinking, and females have their way of thinking. So
oof.
I'm going to be representing the females. He's going to be representing the males.
What station are you going to be doing this on?
DTF Radio.
Get the hell out of here.
Hey, yo,
I didn't check the board. I didn't check the board. Get out. Congratulations.
That sounds like
thank you.
That sounds like a show I want to crash the set.
That's gonna be big, man. That's I'm here 4 days out the week, so I didn't know that. Wow.
Yes. It'll be Wednesdays, from 5 to 6.
Oh, great time.
Okay.
DTF, man. We
making history.
We the blueprint to this internet radio shit, man. We don't
everything
know.
Else is uncivilized.
Basically.
And well, let me just say this. We're glad to have you here on the Vandal Hour with us tonight. You might not be too familiar with the show. This is where we get into our segments on the show. We have a whole bunch of them. This is just one of them. This is where we get into this week.
And the Vandal Hour's news.
This week, for everybody listening, this week, DigiWax and the Vandal Hour released our newest installment of Tags and Hash on the blast by DigiWax.com. You can see it on their website or their Twitter page at DigiWax Media. You can also find it on our Twitter page at the Vandal Hour. This week, we featured the writer Stem Wynan. And remember, every week we'll be bringing you writers from around the city, country, and the world that are getting busy. Make sure you keep up on that. Don't forget also, y'all. Big news, you're going to see a lot of promotion after tonight. Don't forget June 15th, 2016, the Vandal Hour DigiWax Tags and Hash in conjunction with COD Music presents the new New York art show going down at the Paper Box in my side of town, Williamsburg, Brooklyn. We will be there. It'll be art featured from Noxa DOD, Karen Farmer, Shaz Illy, Chris RWK, the 1718 Collective, Hops YNN, J-Lo, Kurt YKK, Vamp WRB, the Get It Gang Movement, many, many more. Also, we got music performances, Provolone P, Cover, COD, Ivo Huli, Conan, Large Amount, M. Easter, Butter Nano, Another Winsburg Affiliate, and a lot of stuff is going on in that show, man.
It will be a lituation. If y'all came out to the Vandal Hour Under the Influence show, then y'all already know how we give it up. I state facts. It will be epic. Tell a friend to tell a friend.
It will be crazy. We're going to have B-Boying going on. Also, we're going to be having live painting by Wen COD and also the Get It Gang. The Paper Box is a crazy spot. It's in Waynesburg, Brooklyn. It's very, like, it's a dope spot, man. You already know. The venues get bigger fucking with us. So this spot is going to be crazy. We got everybody's going to be the new New York art show. We pushing a new New York tour into different states. So it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, man. Yeah. And you heard us a little while ago. Cali's one of them. You're making history. A few more stops, even overseas. So sure we're indeed. Still working on that.
Hopefully we'll be in Australia in September.
Yeah, man. So look out for that. Vandal Hour was moving. And real quick, once again, shout out to Facts on Wax.
I went viral. I don't always go viral, but when I do go viral, it's never a dull moment. I got another trick up my sleeve for y'all motherfuckers. I'm only going to keep turning the heat up on y'all niggas. So if y'all are trying to copy my wave, my blueprint, my steez, it's about to get crazy for y'all. Yeah.
And if you missed it, you can go check out the videos on our Vandal Hour Instagram.
I don't think
page.
They missed it, E. That shit reached like 20 something on our
they
page.
Definitely didn't miss it, but you know what? Well, what happened was Facts on Wax.
I'm an animal.
He's into a lot of things. And one of the things he posted up, one of the videos posted up on the page, our executive producer saw it.
Matter of fact, y'all want to see some of them right now?
Nah, this is what happened. This is what happened. He went through a situation. The situation was taped. It was on his friend's page. It was getting a lot of views, but not that many views. When I took it and put it on our page, the shit went crazy. Let me just say, Facts on Wax is like,
animal.
No, but he is like the face of the Vandal Hour.
Yes.
You know, that mask is very, very well known.
When y'all niggas talk about Copic, my name is the motherfucking topic. This is the last of the Mohicans. I ran through 500 of these shits. I got niggas coming from West Bubblefuck. I had a nigga hit my phone the other day talking about, yo, fam, if you get another 500, I'll drive from Boston. So, yo, niggas in my DM box playing games talking about, yo, fam, you want a tattoo? Nah, nigga. I'm just saying, though. My next video, when I go viral, it will be another epic moment. I stayed fast.
Yo, let me just say this, man. We went to the, we did some media work today at the Bushwick Collective Block Party.
That was popping.
Yo, shout out to all the people that came up to us and showed support, bought bandanas, who we interviewed. We interviewed a lot of people. Who did your interview earlier before I got there?
Yo, we chopped it up with mad people. We chopped it up with Nerds 2DX. We chopped it up with Minus and his girl Love Notes. We chopped it up with AC2 and his motherfucking moms. We chopped it up with motherfucking, what's that? Smith & Wesson. Hey, yo, Tech, I'm sorry for fucking up your group's name, but, yo, I was on 2 Nutcrackers and a 40.
Yo, he was calling Smith & Wesson Helter Skelter 3 times.
What?
we had a good time. We got to interview Sean P's wife, Bernadette.
Shout out to her, man.
Let me just say this. She supports the show. And so when we came up to her and we asked for the interview, she was about to say no. And I said, it's the Vandal Hour. She was like, I'll do it. And we had a good conversation. She looked very like touched by our conversation. So shout out to Bernadette. Shout out to Sean P. Rest in peace. To the God.
For all y'all niggas, I was home today jerking off, doing the things, whatever y'all was doing, females playing with their pussies. Y'all missed out on history tonight. I mean, Joel Ortiz, he really put it on for Brooklyn.
Joel,
today.
What up?
So yeah, we got a lot of interviews. That will be up hopefully by next week, Dre. Yeah, by next week we should have that. We got them performing. We got the interviews. We got everything. So make sure you check out that new Vandal Hour On Scene next week, featuring the Bushwick Collective Block Party.
It was so popping that it was raining, and I shit still ain't shut down the show. Shout out to them cops I cursed out today because they told me I couldn't wear my mask. But you had a nigga in a pink rubber suit and a dick on his head. Get the fuck out of here.
Yep. Now check this out. This is when we get into
this weekend, FanDuel's flexing.
No. Like, you see, that's the Nutcrackers. See, the Nutcrackers are still in the system. It's all right.
Oh, wait.
It's all right.
No, let me do my part for you, homie, because I see you want it. You want one. So check this out. This is when we get into Facts on Wax, Mark of the Week. So, Facts.
What's poppin'?
What's the Mark of the Week?
Hey, yo. The Mark of the Week is a motherfucking Bic. And I'm not talking about a lighter. I'm really talking about a Bic marker. I know most people, like, y'all hear Bic, y'all think a lighter. But, yeah, this right here is a motherfucking Bic marker. And these shits are really hard to find. But, you know, Facts on Wax, I be chasing these shits down. I find them. And I keep presenting that to you, Mark of the Week.
So, let me ask you, why did you choose that one?
Why did I choose it? I mean, look at this shit. If you want to fuck shit up, then this is the perfect marker. Look at the tip. It's chiseled. This shit don't even got paint on it yet. So if y'all niggas would like to purchase this, then hit my DM box. Y'all might get the cop it on air. Who knows?
Oh, yeah. Just to let y'all know, we got our PayPal account set up.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so we will be selling all the merchandise and Facts on Wax products and the 1718 Collective products through our page and through our website. So make sure y'all check that out.
But, nope. Yeah, I definitely picked this motherfucking marker because it does damage. And if you like to write on windows, then this is the motherfucking marker to do so with. And it got some special ink, so when you do write on the window, when they try to buff it, it ain't coming off. I state facts. Big magic marker, the marker of the week. Fuck with me. You know I got it.
Now, this week on...
Vandals flexing. Now, check it out. We feature Walls being done by Yes One. We also featured Tone MST. We featured Nerd 2DX. Last week, we featured a tag by motherfucking MQ. I state facts. I will never lie to you. Now, if you want to be featured on Vandals Flexing, y'all niggas can hit my motherfucking DM box. If y'all got my number, y'all can text me a picture. Y'all got Sinatra number, send him a picture. Send my motherfucking producer a picture, and we'll post that shit. But remember, it can never be no toy shit, because it will not get no burn. But... as far as this week coming up in Vandals Flexing, I was so much on the motherfucking scene this week, I got that shit covered. I state facts. I will never lie to you. Now, this week in regulars news.
I don't know if everybody heard about, everybody knows Troy Ave got into a situation not too long ago, and there's new updates on his case.
Yeah, as they reported last week, they was blaming him for all the, you know, for the shooting completely. Now they are looking for a second shooter.
Yep.
They're actually saying that he's not the one. He was actually shot and not shot in the leg. So a lot of things is happening. You know, I jumped out the window and thought it was something was going down like that. But as you see, like the media, the tele-live vision, you know what I mean? They lie to you, so you don't know what the fuck is going on. Mm-mm. But as I said, I don't like no black man going to jail. So, you know, I still say the same thing. I hope he does get out of this shit somehow, but you know, shit happens, man. But that's the update on that one.
Definitely hold your head.
Word.
Also, I know everybody saw this, the silverback gorilla over there in Cincinnati Zoo. The child fell inside to the place where the animal was, and they killed the gorilla and saved the child, got out the zoo. That got a big buzz all over social media.
That was viral as well.
Yeah. Also,
wait, time out. But what's your opinion on that?
Oh, listen, I mean, I got friends that have kids, so I don't have kids. You know what I mean? And I had to put myself in a situation where if I had kids,
what would you have done?
I would have wanted them to kill the animal too if I had kids. My first emotional feeling, but this is what I explained to my friend because I was against it in the beginning. And I said, this is one of the main reasons why I feel you shouldn't have animals in captivity. You know what I mean? For one reason, the animal was where he was supposed to be.
Right.
He didn't leave his, he didn't endanger anybody or he didn't come out. He was where, the gorilla was where it was supposed to be.
Y'all niggas took him out his habitat so y'all can make a little bit of shmoney.
Now the child falls in. However, you know, a lot of blame was put on the parent. For, I guess, a small time. I wasn't there, so I don't know. But they saying a small time of where she's turned away and the kid ended up. And the argument was basically was, I said, listen, I don't think you should have animals in captivity. You know what I mean? If a shark bites somebody, you in the beach, they don't send a team out there to go look for this shark that just ripped your leg off. You know what I mean? They just don't. So I felt it was a loss. I was just, at the end, glad that the child was safe. And that happened to the kid, but I also felt bad, extremely bad for the animal.
But you talked about if you were a parent, but Would you have taken the same actions as the parent before shooting the gorilla? Would you have jumped in behind your child? That was also,
I would have definitely, you know what? To be honest with you, I would think I would.
Me being a father?
But you don't know. You don't, because you jumping in there, I mean, if at the time you have 3 seconds to think about it, jumping in there could probably agitate an animal like that, very territorial animals. She did seem extremely calm on some of the audio they released first. Then they released the 911 call, which was a total different. She was very erratic.
I think that's crazy that you say you have 3 seconds to think about it. You don't know. But I remember I had posted on Instagram. I spoke my thoughts about the incident where the father ran and left his daughter when she was getting raped or attacked by. And that was an uproar. Like, oh, that's her father. Why didn't he protect her? What's the difference between that and trying to protect your kid from a gorilla?
Well, go ahead.
Me being a father of two kids, I don't give a fuck. I would have hopped in that motherfucking gorilla pit to get my kid. I ain't going to wait till y'all niggas shoot this motherfucker. He could have killed my kid in that 2 seconds.
Absolutely.
That's my question about the whole situation. No. I feel like as a parent, action should have.
No matter what, should have went
right
down there too.
Before it resulted to that. Because when you watch the videos, who's really the animals in the situation? Who's the animals? Because the gorilla wasn't harming the child from what I seen.
And that was my argument as well. And they also have footage of this happen. This is not the first time.
I ask that question all the time. Who's really the animal? I had a dog. She died last year. Rest in peace, Bria. That was my child. That's my daughter. You know, I remember I took her on the train one time and she was sitting in my bag, minding her business. She was actually asleep. And the kid next to me kept kicking the bag because they seen a dog in the bag.
Oh, that nigga would have got kicked.
So I had to grab the child's leg, you know, off instant. Or, mm-hmm. You know, people don't understand.
Without even thinking
right,
about
people
it.
People don't understand. They think because she's a pet, she's less of importance because she's not a human. But that's my child just as anyone else. I feed her. I bathe her. I, you know, walk her. She's dependent on me. And so, you know, I grabbed and the lady was like, you know, the lady got up and started wilding on me. And I'm like, miss, who's the animal here? My dog or your daughter?
Mm-hmm. True.
And you know, you bring up and also a good point. I don't know if they think, I know one thing I did hear about, there's like a team of people in the zoo that when situations like that happen, they're the ones that give the final word.
The SWAT team.
And that the animal was so big, they were scared to tranquilize it, and if it didn't work fast enough or they missed agitate the animal, it could have, you know, harmed the child. Mm-hmm. It was a crazy situation, and you put it like that about being an animal lover, and it's crazy, and I have to agree with you, and I would say that the best part about it is that the kid came out.
I'm going
to
end it on this note, right? Yo, Tarzan, he was a little boy in the jungle. He grew up with an ape, and look at him.
It was great. No, real quick before we get
on the
Jungle
subject. The Jungle Book was a great movie.
Great movie.
Yeah, I heard it was.
And there was also a video released in the mid-90s. This happened in a zoo, and the child fell and was actually injured, and the gorilla picked the child like how a human would hold a child.
They have all these movies of how gorillas and apes, how they are right.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah, I ain't going front. They just wanted to kill that gorilla, so that was an excuse. Oh, the kid fell in the cave.
The gorilla birthday was the day before, too.
Oh, my God.
Look at that.
I didn't even know.
The day before, Hammond. I forgot. I think the silverback was called Hammond or Hammond or something like that.
That's a fucked up way to end your birthday, right? You celebrate, then the next day you just bang, bang, bang. Hold that.
Last but not least, y'all, you know, we woke up to some bad news. Muhammad Ali passed on, one of the biggest legends, if not in sports, in boxing history in general. Crazy. Reports were first he was in there with some respiratory problems. And then at this age, and if you follow Muhammad Ali, you know his health conditions, you knew that this was going to come up. I think it was worse. Now, you know, Prince, right after Muhammad Ali, it's like the legends that we grew, that I was raised off of, that my parents and my elders put, are disappearing as time goes by, man. And it's a shock.
That's how you know the age, you're going up in age.
Oh,
man.
Let's not even talk about that.
That's how you know. Yeah. But I'm going to say this. Muhammad Ali, man, a lot of people call him the first rapper. Mm. You know what I mean? He put words together eloquently. rhythmically, you know what I mean, rhyme-wise, and he did what we call a scat. Dolemite did the same thing, and like the Last Poets did the same thing. It's called a scat. It's an old black word rhythm type thing, and that's what basically they try to say is the foundation of hip hop comes from that. You know what I mean? So a lot of people call Muhammad Ali one of the first like MCs. You know what I mean? Besides that, his influence in the boxing world was crazy. He actually took a stand against America by joining the NOI and refusing to go to war. At the time. I think he was sentenced to 3 years.
Yes.
He refused to fight again until the law was, until that shit was redacted. He was very outspoken and with a lot of things, man. He was personally taught by Malcolm X. So, you know, the brothers is a deep dude besides just boxing. You know what I mean? So, shout out to the dude, Muhammad Ali.
He'll beat rest your ass peace. And give you a history lesson all at once.
Yeah. Truly. Rest in peace to the God.
Definitely rest in peace and condolences to his friends and his family. Listen, y'all, we're going to take a short music break with DJ Swift. And when we come back, we're going to have our first guest in the building, Reeps. We'll be chopping it up with the Vandalawa team live here on DTFradio.com. So don't go nowhere.
Tell
y'all.
A friend to tell a friend.
Vandalawa, we on. We making noise. We making history. Tell your grandmother too, motherfucker.
Y'all know how we getting it, man. One question. Rusty Jukes.
I just want to ask you.
And Reed.
Who's the nicest MC, nigga?
I just want to ask you. One question.
Who's that better than
you? I just want to.
Nice as it seems. Crack juice. Pistol whip your shit, stick in the click, clack, clap. That smash, smack. Beating the mad mass. I be the leader of the new school while the rest is truant.
Yeah, that's right. Y'all know what it is.
But I guess you blew it. Piss on your grave. Now you're all correct.
DJ Swift, the Vandal Hour.
Life on my right, the pistol was left. Sell a black nigga, crack white.
That's right. Remember, June 15th. June 15th is going down.
Stay dirty in the tub.
The new New York tour.
Shoot your rap book, rifle your hood, rock.
COD.
Wild, funny style, Michael.
718. Yeah. Vandal Hour.
Price bad, move on the beats. Better watch where you walk for
be stabbed. Prince Polygamy, Conan, Ivo Hooley.
I just wanna ask you one question.
Why the fuck is your bitch checking me while she with you?
I just wanna ask you one question.
Why the fuck I ain't getting yet?
I just wanna one question.
You want your motherfucking jaw broke, nigga.
I just wanna ask you. I want you to know.
Yo. I don't answer questions when they ask by the police. Cause I don't know you and him, and him and you don't know me. It must have been a mix-up. I wasn't in Brownsville. I was out in the style with some bitch getting my dicks up. What you mean, how the fuck his chain got around my neck? How his watch on my wrist? He gave it to me as a gift. I don't know how all your money got in my pocket, but your bitch in my bag cause your honey out of pocket. I'm beating niggas half to death, ref, you gotta stop it. When Master P dropped Mike Tyson, you better cop it. If you don't, your chest, we gone. Heckle and catch it, and not even a vest could slow him down and block it. Who told you that I buy things, sell them, and make a profit? That's just an air hustler, fussing and making gossip. The name's Reekin', big business is what I'm repping, and I'm tired of giving answers. Quit asking me fucking questions.
I just wanna ask you one question.
Why your ugly ass moms ain't use birth control?
I just wanna ask you one question.
Why the fuck your Tim's always leaning like the Tower of Pisa?
I just wanna ask you one question.
How the fuck you got a Caesar with waves in the front and an afro shag in the back?
I just wanna ask you. I want you to know.
Yo, how it took you 30 years just to sound alright? When I spit my first rhyme, niggas knew I was nice. How your girl gave brain to me, Buckets the rain. On tour, ran the train, but you love her the same. Why?
Give me that from Butter Nano.
I don't know who the fuck you think I am, boo.
I don't.
But lying be the one thing I can't do. Niggas said, Nano, let me hold some. Homeboy, you couldn't hold the door for him.
got no business talking to them. Strictly they want niggas and more bitches that's walking with them. Handouts I never hand off. Life a bitch, you just asking for a hand job. I'ma make a toes curl. He said, I know you's a cold nigga. Nigga, it's a cold world. I'ma light it to the spoon, watch the dope swirl. One thing I want in this world is this whole world. Yeah, the Moreno Montana. A scar face if I can't reach the hammer. Tell me that's aggression in my grammar, but I still move smooth, elegant in my manner. I'm the shit, can't tell if it do stink. Bunch of paper, closet full of loose leaf.
Better start coming to the club with some women, my nigga. Some women, my nigga.
Yeah, that's that Berry life. Have one. Baby Jesus.
My Spanish brothers on the brew.
St. Pierre, y'all know how we getting it. That's COD.
The Haitian fling, she on the hate thing. You know white girls, they do anything. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have
one. I'm just letting y'all know I'm going back to them strip clubs, so y'all know I got some heat for y'all.
I'm loving my women, they all come with costumes. You know my style, turn the club to a brothel. My VIP lit and it look like a crowd full. I'm boning this bitch, turn her ass to a fossil. My Spanish broad is on a Bugatti. My blackberries on a Syrah. The Haitian fling, she on a Henny thing. You know white girls, they do anything. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one. I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one. I'm sharing my bitches, you care for your bitches, your swag is a hazard.
Got so many bitches, it's hard to keep count. I keep turning her out, grabbing her mouth, pushing her south. Twist up her tongue, then I'm pimping her out. She don't like bitches, but she eat pussy. Me and your bitches getting fucked if you keep looking. Rolling up the skunk, we just keep.
Cali, understand, we gonna be in the building.
All my bitches,
I got so much bitches, you niggas can have one.
Cali, we gonna be in the building. California, we gonna be in the building. My Bay Area girls, y'all better come down south and come see the boy. We gonna be out there in August.
Bitches, you care for your bitches, your swag is a hazard.
Ayo, what's poppin'? Peace, Vandals. Tonight on the Vandal Hour, we got a motherfucking Queens representative in the building. He's a mean-ass artist. He's one badass illustrator. It is my pleasure, the Vandal Hour's pleasure to introduce to you my motherfucking nigga, Reeps.
What's good, y'all? What's good?
Ayo, Reeps, what's poppin'? I'm feeling that hat.
Chillin', man. Thank you, bro. Good looking.
You already know. Yo, how was your day?
My day so far has been quiet.
My shit was epic.
Yo, I heard.
I don't know if y'all follow me on Snapchat, but I seen a motherfucker while I was busting a leak in the train station. This nigga fell in the tracks. Really, Vince? That nigga had the whole train station screaming. I stayed facts. Yo, today was the Bushwick Collectors block party. Did you check that out?
I didn't, yo. I didn't know it was today.
Oh, man.
I wish I would have known. Yo, nobody hit me up. No.
You missed out on history, man. I should have called you. Plasma should have called you, too. He had a wall out there. All the kids was taking pictures in front of his shit. Jada tore the stage down. Joel Ortiz tore the stage down. For the people who like cake, it was a lot of cake out there.
Yeah. I know. I seen. I missed out. It's all good. I'll be there tomorrow.
All right. Yo, right now, there's a lot of collectors like walls taking over in NYC right now. How do you feel about the non-writers doing permission worlds in our neighborhood instead of having like local writers doing the damn thing?
From the art perspective, it's cool that everybody gets down, but they should pay a little more homage to who was here first. You know what I'm saying? We've been doing it for a lot longer. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we're the ones that put the art up on the walls before they did. You know what I'm saying?
We paved the way for these
exactly.
niggas.
Exactly. And now they're coming over here getting that stream wrong.
Oh, we got a little technical difficulties here.
So, okay, we good now?
We good.
Got you.
Do you feel like they should come to the local writers first before they go to...
Yeah, I feel that way. I also feel that a lot of writers should also step up a little bit, too. And that's be like, yo, you know what? If if you guys want to see more graft, then just step up and be like, yo, this is what I want to do. I want to do your walls. Like, what's up? You know, a little more hustle. You can't just sit back and be like,
wait for the call.
Yeah, yo, you can't just sit back and wait
for the call. I ain't going front. Man. Next year, I'm definitely trying to paint one of the motherfucking walls. Hey, yo, yeah, Cobra should, paint? Yo. Them niggas was giving out a lot of paint. Like, everywhere, all I went to, it was like 100 cans or more. Like, you had a few niggas, like, just doing, like, black and white murals.
Yeah.
And these niggas has, like, so many colors on the floor. And they do street art. Like, they not gonna put that shit to good use, nah, but you put that shit in my hand. Oh, man.
Otherwise, right?
Yo. But, yo, you started writing in the late 80s, early 90s, right, in Queens. Do you feel what's going on today with the street art movement could have happened back then?
Nah.
Why definitely not?
A lot of things. First of all, the times were different back then. That's number one.
That's a fact.
So, like, there wasn't too many people like really like doing like stickers and stuff like that. Like Koss and Revs used to do that shit a lot. They were the original ones.
Trendsetters.
Yeah, the trendsetters. And it's like, I feel like as far as street art goes, a lot of people started like finding like an easier way of getting over with the system. Mm-hmm. So like, it's cool to an extent. But at the same time, it's like I don't like people that like street artists that just like copy and paste shit and throw it up.
Okay.
If you can't draw this shit yourself, then you're not an artist. I'm sorry. Like, you
I
know,
agree.
Anybody could do a collage, you know?
Do you feel that street artists phasing out of graph right now in the current time?
No, I wouldn't say phasing out. I mean, it's getting a little bit more of a graffiti appeal, I feel like. You know, like all the poses are starting to like get rooted out.
Okay.
You know, so all the ones that are really like keeping it real, that are closer to graffiti than street art, is the ones that are still shining, you know?
Okay. Real quick, poser. You said poser.
Mm-hmm.
What makes them a poser?
Just like in it for the minute. Like, you wasn't really down like last week. You're just looking for a scene to like settle into. So it's like, they're usually the ones that got all, like, you know, all the brand name shit, all the top shit on lock. Like, you know, this is,
you know,
meanwhile with me, it's like, yo, I'll use whatever, man.
Whatever's there, get the job done.
Get the job done.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Yo, since you are a Queens writer, right, tell us a little bit about the graph scene of Queens back when you first started. R.I.P. to Coin.
Word. Yo, the graph scene in Queens was crazy back then when I started, because it was phasing out of the trains. And that's when they started doing like big full color fillings on the street. You know, everyone started doing triple outlines. Like, the street started getting smacked really hard, and Queens got smacked very hard. A lot of big writers out of Queens back then.
A lot of kings came from Queens.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Corn, VE. That's just a few to name off the top. My nigga JD, BTW.
Yep.
When you think about Queens graffiti now versus Queen graffiti scene back in the days, what you feel has changed?
Oh, it's definitely cleaner. That's for sure. It's definitely cleaner. They, in my opinion, they come down harder on Queens because we're closer to Long Island. I feel like so. It's
that's
like,
true.
They're trying to clean it up, so it's like the entryway to Long Island from out the city could be a little more cleaner. You know what I'm saying? And they come down a lot harder on Queens riders. That's a fact.
Yo.
Yeah?
Yeah. If you get caught bombing in Queens, it's not the same as getting caught bombing in, like, another borough, I feel like.
Oh, that's...
Yo,
yeah.
You get caught in Queens, like, them niggas will really try to rock your boat. I state facts. I will never lie to you.
Yep, facts.
I got caught for catching a tag in Queens. Them niggas tried to get me a bullet in jail. I had to do 20 days community service. And if I ain't complete that 20, then I had to do a bullet. So, yeah, they definitely on their bullshit. Yo, Reeks, when you think of Queens graffiti, right, who are a few people in your eyes that made an impact? Like, when you're talking about, like, top five. Like, who name is in your top five that comes out of Queens?
Are we talking about back then in general or present day?
Nah, we talking about back then. All that shit now is watered down.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. I'm just stating facts.
Word. I have to say Giz sticks out to me. Giz sticks out to me big because his feelings, I remember being the one, like, the whole FTR movement back then, they were really putting in most of the work, I feel like.
What's your favorite train line, like, back in the days? Like, what was your favorite train line, like, to look at in Queens? Mine was the 7.
Yeah, I have to say the 7. I mean, I'm closer to the M line. So, like, I used to actually hit the M line back in the day, so I would see it more often, but going to see the 7 line was always a treat. It was always a treat. It was always a special thing to me. Like, yo, I'm going to take the 7 today instead. And, like, those rooftops.
Take my time.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. How long you been involved in the graffiti life?
I started writing in 89. I was 9 years old. I was a young kid and, like.
So you've seen a lot of stuff.
A lot. Yeah, and I took notice of graph when I was like 5. You know? When I was a little kid, I saw fillings on the train, and I remember just wanting to know what that was.
Do you remember your first tag?
My first tag?
Or the first time you, the first time you grabbed the can.
The first time I grabbed the can, I was already writing Reaps. I was already writing Reap at the time when I first grabbed the can. But the first time I caught a tag, I wrote BW with a pencil.
Okay.
And I don't know why I chose those letters. I don't know what it was. Just something about it. I was like, I'm going to do this real quick. That was the first. I never stuck with that tag after that. I just called one tag. I was a little kid. I had a pencil. I was like, yo, I'm going to write on this.
And that's how it started.
That was it.
That's how it usually starts right there.
Yeah.
Listen, y'all, we're going to take a short music break real quick with DJ Swift. And when we come back, we're going to finish this conversation with Reaps in the building on the Vandal Hour on DTFradio.com, y'all.
Tell a friend to tell a friend of Vandal Hour. We on live. Ah!
Once again, that's our Ivo Hooli, Scammers.
The money pile up, living like a Milo. Life was never easy, no one tried to find us. I just put that rope out, told my niggas come on. Fuck up on my dope house, bitch from Tijuana. Kill that pussy dope, stop breaking through the condo. You don't want no smoke now, told them niggas line up. Backward got me faded, faded, looking Asian. Both my bitches, they in, they in. I'm their main man. I can see it poking and popping, dancing with them. If I put that ass on the camera, you might get famous. She probably think that I'm a scammer. All she ever see is cameras. Hey. Only fuck her on the random. Heard them niggas trying to grab.
Yeah, that's right, that's right. Stay tuned, man. We still got Reaps in the building, baby. We got Reaps in the building. We got the lovely Shay 2 Real Peters in the building sitting alongside. Yeah, that's right. That's that another one. That's another banger right here from Ivo Hooli. Insomnia. That's that COD fam. Yo, we getting there rocking.
Hey. I can sleep at night.
This right here. I call this Facts on Wax theme music. My man Facts on Wax, stay grinding, dogs. If you follow him on Snapchat, you will see this man lives his life. He lives what he talks about, boy. That's the rat guard right there. Ah.
I got insomnia for real, but shout out to my motherfucking coolie.
Dang.
Yo, Ivo, you got a motherfucking banger right here, my nigga. Gang. Baba, what is talking?
I can sleep at night.
Yeah.
Sleep at night.
Yeah.
I'm on a blue ticket, honey, huh? Money down.
Once again, I'm gonna let y'all know. June 15th is going down. Paper box. Hashtag the new New York. COD Vandal Hour 1718.
money then right.
Swizzy,
I'm from the heart of the Bronx. I'm from the heart of the Bronx. All the fun niggas that come through and play if you want. You know what money is on. AK as big as an arm and my probably Megatron. I do it all for the God. Hit his chest until it's warm. Poppin' tags out the phone, poppin' tags out the phone. We made it.
Got that new mixtape coming. I got that new mixtape for the month coming.
Hey, I barely speak to Ebon, had to keep her.
Escape from New York mixtapes. The Escape from New York, DJ Swift, Vandal Hour.
When she called me buzzin' the cell, my mama went loca. Pedigree made a young nigga a meal, serving that compra. Never knew all this time would go by. Product of the street, the shit would go mine.
That's right, follow me on that Instagram. Bye. Follow me on my Twitter at DJ Swift 37.
Me around with the K, I'm bumping Max B. Need 100 million.
Do remember, follow the Vandal Hour.
We got magazines.
Twitter, Instagram.
Trying to hit me with the Rico.
Snapchat.
See my team went.
At the Vandal Hour.
Keep going. I got a shiny hub.
That's what it is. Y'all see mathematics up there. Reppin' that, the Vandal Hour, we serious in here.
Getting money then right, getting money then right. I got a shiny
hug. Do remember, man. Follow up, follow up. Shade Too Real Peters. Follow her on the Instagram at Too Real. TOOREAL. Too Real, let's go.
Man, bitch, I make it back. I don't touch nothing, I'm laying back. Money, my gang, and my drugs, I don't play with that. I pull it up till I'm lagging. In these streets, I'm never lacking. I roll with my hitters keep ratchets. Enjoy the hype while I last. Black circles on my eyes. I've been breaking every night. Vising, couldn't fix the problem, boy. You ain't really living life. Bitch, I'm famous in the banner. K came with a banana. Tony plus, be French, probably why the world stays Montana.
That's right.
Fans coming any minute. They ain't on the niggas snitching. It be niggas that you really did shit.
Follow us, follow us. We doing a lot of things. Money, money. Get that Vandal Hour merchandise.
Yeah, these niggas.
Get us up, man. We got that PayPal cracking.
On the mission, looking for the toss. Bitches asking when we hooking up, man. If the pussy really good enough, I'm fucking in the stew while I'm cooking up. Dreams of getting to the UK. Flight to London, tell them touche. Doing me, but what you say, tell my whole.
Do remember, I'm gonna be at the Blue Lounge next week. Tuesday and Thursday night, I'm gonna be at the Blue Lounge in Astoria, Queens.
Sleep at night, I'm on a blue ticket, honey, huh?
This song right here is for the Vandal Hour, baby. Insomnia, we don't sleep, baby. We grind all day.
I can't sleep at night. I can't sleep at night. I'm on a blue ticket, honey, huh?
DTF Radio.
Getting money then right.
Ayo, Vandals, what's poppin'? We back in the motherfucking building. DJ Swift was just doing his things on the ones and twos. My nigga Ivo Julio, like me and him, we both got insomnia. That track was fire. Ayo, Reeps, Too Real, this goes for both of y'all Reeps. When you fuck a girl and she got good pussy, you gotta lie to your friends, right? And tell them her pussy stinks so niggas don't try to beat. Too Real, this goes for you too. Like, if you fuck with a nigga and he got good dick, you gotta lie to your friends and tell him that shit was whack so they don't try to smash. I state facts, I will never lie to you. Ayo, yo, Reeps, what's poppin'? Who are some of your influences in the graph scene in motherfucking Cop Killer Queens?
First and foremost was JRC back in the day.
Okay.
JRC was a big influence on me because a year into graffiti, that's when I started seeing his pieces. He was from the neighborhood. I actually caught him one day doing the shines on a sick burner that he had done the night before. And since that day, that's when I started piecing. From that very moment, I was like, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to start doing pieces.
Can I ask a question?
Let's pop it.
You say you caught him. Okay. Mm-hmm. My question is, when do you guys do this? I see graffiti all the time. How did you catch somebody? Because I always wanted to know, when do these people do this? Because I always see it everywhere I go. I always see it in the train station, but I've never seen anyone actually doing it. So I've always wondered, when does this get done?
Me?
All hours. All hours.
You guys do it in the train station. You'll do it like in front of a bunch of...
You got to be slick. Yeah, we do it all hours of the day, all times of night. Yeah. All hours of the day.
When somebody's doing graffiti right now.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, but it's late. You know, not a lot of people are on the train, so I figured that's when they do it, during the hours that no one is around. I didn't know that it's done all hours of the day.
You follow me a day in my life and shit get real. I do that shit while the sun's still up.
Yep.
Hot boy blocks.
You know what? Sometimes when you see somebody doing something in the daytime, you just get the vibe that he can't be doing something wrong because he's doing it in the daytime, but he is really doing an illegal wall or illegal act at the time. But you figure, you know, since it's daytime, you walk
maybe
by,
he's supposed to be
you'd be
doing
like, maybe
it.
He's supposed to be here doing this. And sometimes that happens. It was a video on Instagram. I forgot. Damn, I hate to forget the artist's name. Mm-hmm. But it was a daytime in the middle of Manhattan on some scaffolding on the side. Broad daylight, tourists walking by. They're looking at him as if he's supposed to be there.
Exactly.
Who was it?
Oh, you was talking about Marty. We actually interviewed him today for the motherfucking Vandal I Want Scene. I state facts. I will never lie to you.
Shout out to him. Broad day.
Shout out to Smart Crew.
Hey, yo. My nigga Reeps, in your pre-interview, right, you spoke about the Videograph movement.
Oh, yeah.
And it was having influence on you. So what was your favorite episode on Videograph? My shit was when Yes One had on that motherfucking police uniform and he was running the tracks writing on that train.
Mine was Videograph 8. Videograph 8 was my favorite Videograph.
Why?
Two reasons. First of all, it's the first one that I ever watched.
Okay.
So
that's one good reason.
Yeah, right away. It was like, wow, so this is what Videograph is? Like, oh, man, this is dope. But, I don't know, that one just stuck out to me the most. Like, I remember the beats that they had during the bombing segments was sick. Sess and Clark, they're doing a piece in like an abandoned pool. And that's actually the first time that I became familiar with Sess. He's another one of my favorites.
Yo, he's an animal.
What is Videograph? Is that viral? Or
Videograph
is it live?
Yeah, it was a video series that they made during the 90s, VHS tapes. And this crew would actually go around and they would film different artists doing their thing. And if you had footage, you could actually send it in and they would put it, you know, they would add it on there.
I didn't know graffiti was such a big
graffiti is popping.
Yeah. I almost went on Videograph.
Graffiti is a big ass business if you use it right. I state facts.
Yeah.
No, and it's a lot bigger than a lot of people. It has its own lifestyle. Like you have graffiti celebrities, I guess you can call them that. You have the elite group.
Sounds like an industry.
And you also have the drama that also comes with this territory.
Oh,
like
it's
just as bad as any other
graffiti.
Beef
this shit is
industry.
A dangerous game. It's a full contact sport. Like you might write over a nigga name, a nigga might come to your crib, beat the shit out you. You got some people who are right over your name and shit, and when you run down on me, yo, it was dark. I was drunk. I've been hearing that shit since 92.
But how do you know who does what?
Cause they'll write their name.
People know who do what.
Name.
Like when you in graffiti, like you on the scene, like you know who's doing what, you know who reps what hood, like this shit is so crazy, like, just by the way a motherfucker, right? Like, you could tell what neighborhood he's from. Sometimes you could tell his background, whether he's black, Spanish, or white. And these are facts.
And then you come into fact, you know, like you said, sometimes you might see a nice piece of art on the wall. It takes them a lot to do it. You know, you're watching out for police, for ops, or for whoever who's going to try to stop you from doing this. And you go risk your life, and then the next day you come and you see somebody put and it gets just as violent as any other beef would in any other type of situation.
So
definitely a world of a lot of things going on in the graffiti world.
That is so dope.
Yo, Reeps, what's poppin'? So tell us a little bit about your evolution in craft. Was you always a bomber first, or did you start off piecing?
No, I started bombing. I did everything in order. I learned how to do the throwies, how to do the tags, how to do the simples, and then I started getting into piecing. Once I knew everything, and I didn't really start getting up until I knew how to do everything.
Okay. Now, since we have Sha here, we're going to break that down. Because, listen, and don't feel out of place. Don't feel out of place because of some of the things I'm still learning up here as well.
Yeah, you learn something new every day, and you guys are teaching me.
There is a difference between the bombing and the piecing. These guys probably
it's
give you a little more detail. Let her know what's the difference between like a tag, a throwy, and a piece.
Well, if you turn around, you look at that canvas right there, ZA1OGM, that's a motherfucking tag. Now, if you look at the canvas in the front of you with the JD on it, that is a motherfucking filling. That's a throw up. Some people color it in. They could color it in silver, outline in black, grab a summer squash, put a triple around that, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. And you on to the next. Now, you got some people who, like, stand on the motherfucking scene and they really get, like, technical and difficult with it.
That's the piecing.
That's the piecing part of it where you whip out mad colors. You might want an arrow to pop out from here, arrow to pop out from there, and that shit take time. And some people, like, who do things like that, like, they might not want to get into beef because they don't want their hard work that they just spent 5 hours on that wall to get ragged by a nigga who came through in 15 minutes and just did a quick ass fill. Like, that shit breaks hearts, and I done broke a few of those.
Going through your Instagram page, I see you have some dope pieces when you do your joints. What are you focusing on when you start your work? Like, is you focused on the style, your colors? Your, what is, or let me say, what's the thing you focus most on?
I focus on the execution as a whole. That's what I focus on, the whole thing looking exactly how I wanted it to look before I put it on the wall. Whatever it may be, it could be a tag, it could be a piece, it could be a throw up, whatever I'm gonna do, I want it to look exactly how I pictured it before I put it up.
Yo, I wish y'all could see his motherfucking picture book. The other day, me and the homie, we was in his studio smoking blunts, chopping it up, doing the things we like to do. He showed me one of his picture books. Yo, the shit that he does with a spray can, you be like, yo, what the fuck? Like, you did all of that?
Thanks, yo.
I stayed facts. Word. Yo, I see you have a lot of abstract work, right? Like, you doing that on the walls or on canvas? Like, what's popping?
I'm both. I've done already like 4 or 5 of those abstract pieces on walls in different spots. And on canvases, I got about 10 on deck right now.
Yo, matter of fact, y'all actually want to see some of his artwork, go look at my Instagram right now. I got a motherfucking picture that I took like 2 days ago, and it says Team Backpack. And that wall right there, him and the homie Plasma Slug, they did their motherfucking thing. So,
yo, I bought a little gift for y'all, too.
Okay.
Oh, the little throw cool, cool. Little
yeah, we like treats up here.
Definitely be added to the collection here.
That's fire right there. I like that. The motherfucking Pacers colors.
Let me see that. Let me see that. You hit it on the nose right there, though. Pacers. But you had the wrong color, the wrong team. This is the Golden State Warriors color.
All right, well, you could. Well.
Shout out to the homie Steph Curry.
Hey, yo. I didn't get it wrong, though, because I didn't get it wrong, though. Yo, the Indiana Pacers, they actually got that motherfucking blue and yellow. I don't look at sports, but I know what the fuck I'm talking about.
It's a little bit different color, but this is definitely the GSW color. And shout out to Reeves. This is definitely going to get front line up here in the Vandal Hour, especially while these finals are going on.
My nigga E is crazy. So I take it, E, that's your favorite canvas right now?
Right now, we can go with that because I got a lot of money on them boys. Has anyone ever compared your work to anybody specifically?
Yeah, actually, Mathematics over the phone on the phone interview compared some of my stuff to Futura, and I take that as a big compliment.
Absolutely,
because Futura is the man.
That's the motherfucking man, right?
Yeah, and he's still doing shit that's unbelievable still to this day. So,
could you see the similarities that he was talking about?
After he said it, yeah. After he said it, cool. Yeah, I definitely saw it. I was like, okay, I see that. All right.
Nah. For me, like, going to your studio and, like, seeing the things you do, right, checking you out on Instagram, I see you do these stick figures with detail, like, faces. How did you come up with that? Because that shit is a pretty fresh idea you got popping off. My favorite one you did, actually, that I seen in your studio recently is Jesus.
Yeah, put the Christ in Christmas. That's a Jesus piece that I did. I was actually chilling with this shorty one night, and she was looking at my artwork, and she was like, wow. She was like, I can't even do a stick figure. And I was like, I can. And that was it. After that, it was born. I've been doing those for years, too. So
everything starts at some place. Yeah. You know, it's crazy. So when you get to the stories of how things started, you would never guess that's where they came from.
Word. Yo, y'all got to come with me one day to check his studio out. If y'all lucky, maybe I'll take one of y'all with me and y'all can see what the fuck I'm talking about. Like, if y'all see the wall he got in his studio, y'all be like, yo, what the fuck? Like, that's really a stick figure? Yo, he does things, peoples. I state facts.
Now, the graph culture right now and what's going on in graph, do you feel like it's being pushed forward or it's more stagnant right now?
I would say that despite the differences of now and back then, or however people want to look at it, I think the fact that it's still going, I think the fact that we're even here on the radio show talking about it, and that's the reason why I'm here, is like, it's obviously just still going forward. I mean, it might take a little turn this way, it might take a little turn that way, you know, trends
as
come and go.
Does,
but I think the fact that it's still alive, I think it's definitely moving forward. If you go anywhere around the world and there's graffiti everywhere. I've been to South America, there's pieces, illegal pieces, full color burners on the streets. You know what I mean? So it's like that impact. Everywhere I've been around the world, I've seen graffiti everywhere.
Real quick, where have you been?
I've been everywhere.
So, just a few places, because I haven't been anywhere myself. So I just like just some of the places you did graphing.
Oh, where I've done graph or where I've traveled? Well, it's two different things. Okay. I've traveled to some places where you can't do any graph, so it's like.
All right, so let's deal with the places you've done graph outside of here.
Outside of here, I've done stuff in Cali. I've done stuff in Ecuador. I've done stuff. But not anything big. Like no, but yeah, but definitely. Just tags, you know, because I was visiting.
It's the nature. It goes with you where you go. I understand.
Amsterdam, actually. I've been there a few times. I did actually most of my out-of-town stuff has been in Amsterdam.
That's dope.
Yeah.
I was talking about Amsterdam today.
I need a vacation.
Amsterdam is popping. I got a friend always writing me out there.
Yeah.
I be trying to figure out, though, if he's trying to kidnap me and shit, because I seen that movie Taken, and, you know, they kidnapped me. They kidnapped New Yorkers for money. I stayed back. Yo, Reeps. Since we're talking about your stick figures and your pieces, like, have you ever combined both of them on a wall together? Yeah. If not, would you do so?
No, yeah, I have. I've done it before. And I'll still continue to do it as well.
Mm. All right. Yo.
That was sharp.
Can you, like, straight the to next the motherfucking time you're going point. To do some, going to do a wall, can I come?
Of course
can
you
can. Can I, like, because I could do the bubble letters and stuff. Uh-oh.
Hey, wait a minute.
She's getting the itch. It starts right here.
Yep,
I know how to do that.
You do bubble letters?
Yeah.
All right, so before we leave tonight, we're going to have you hit the Vandal Hour book because I want to see what you could do.
Oh, you're going in the book. Uh-oh, that's big. That's big.
All right, well, we want to see what you do because, like, as you can see, you look at the wall, 1718 Collective. Those are motherfucking peoples right there. And they put together a lot of art shows. So if you got some popping work, then my people right there, they'll make your dream come true. I state facts. Yo, Reeps, who do you feel is really pushing the culture forward these days? Who?
I got to give it all to my man, Plasma Slugs. He's doing big things. He's got he's like the biggest hustler I've ever seen.
Definitely.
Art shit. He's a 24/7 moving machine. He does not stop. He does not stop. And he does a lot of extracurricular things. He does a lot of community events. He does a lot of shows. Like, he's really, really pushing things forward, in my opinion.
I've seen a few of his, I guess, products. Speaking of.
It's popping. Yep. For your niggas who want to know my nigga Plasma up to, one day I went to the studio, right? I stepped in some dirty ass water, fucked up my kicks. He gave me a pair of kicks. He gave me some motherfucking socks that had his Plasma Slug on it. One day I was in the studio chopping it up. I met a dude named Astro. He was doing drugs and shit. That nigga popped up with one of these motherfucking bags. I had butt in it with a motherfucking Plasma Slug. He also passed me another one that has some acid tabs in it. So for a motherfucker who grinds, Plasma Slug is definitely one of them. Wow. And I think that Ivo Huli song should be his theme song because Plasma definitely has insomnia. Like right now, everybody else sleeping, that nigga is home working. I state facts. I will never lie to you. And what y'all just saw on air ain't really happened.
and a big shout out to Plasma Slug. Definitely putting in work, man. Reeps, any last words? Anything you want to say to the people that's watching or listening on to the show?
Thank you for the support, number one. And, you know, like, also, like, always show support, like, to people who are actually doing things, you know, trying to move things forward, you know? Like, you got a lot of people that are just idolizing, like, people that they really shouldn't be, you know what I mean? I feel like everybody should be more in tune to doing things that are going to move everybody forward, you know what I mean?
I totally agree. Support. I always say, we say this when we have our little powwows, support is all we got.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? A lot of people doing the independent thing right now, and one of the main foundations of that is support. So if you know somebody who's doing something, man, in a good way, support it, hold them down, and put your pride to the side, man. Let somebody get up. Listen, we want to give you a shout out. Appreciate you coming out here to the Vandal Hour, showing us some love. Definitely have your canvas up. On a set, you definitely see
That's
it in our
fact.
Shows.
Thank you,
man. And welcome back anytime, man.
Yeah, hell yeah. Can I give a couple shout outs?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Thing. All right, definitely shout out to Plasma Slug. That's my right hand. We've been playing for a long, long time. That's my boy. Shout out to Kids in Brooklyn. Shout out to Lil Music. And a big rest in peace to Polo One, MSD. Kids in Brooklyn, Minds Over Matter. Shout out to my mom.
Mama Love, of course, Mama of course.
Shout out to God.
Can never forget Mama Love, and definitely a big shout out to Plasma Slug. He was actually on the first season of the motherfucking Vandal Hour. So after the show, or right now, you could go to YouTube and check that out. I state facts, yeah, but
shout
do
out
it
to
after the show.
In here too, yo. Thank you. Yo.
Appreciate it.
Hey, yo, Swift. Do what the fuck you do.
Yeah, man, we're going to take a quick music break with DJ Swift. And when we come back, we're going to have our second guest in the building.
F you.
You already know. Stay tuned, y'all. Don't go nowhere.
Conan and Prince Polygamy, Gold Slippers. That's that COD, baby. That's that COD, Clean or Dirty. Cover, I see you pimping, you working hard. That new New York tour is gonna be stupid. JFK to LAX.
Understand.
You know I had to bring that back. This is how we doing it, baby. This is that Vandal Hour. We just had a great interview with Reeves. Right about now, we're going to be having FU coming in. FU coming in the building. Let's go.
Like that, we all winners. I'm in my path like that with mall liquor. 40 ounce, pass it back. We all niggas see me in the trap like that with gold slippers. Gold slippers, see me in the trap like that. Gold slippers.
Facts
is on my line, that's a three way. Beast it for the beat, cold cover for the remake. A move you make, it's like it's prepaid. Boy, you need wheels on your feet, you a cheapskate. I go hard for this. Your offerings, baby Jesus, walk around with confidence. Yeah, fuck your marketing. My fan base shit is shaking like it's Parkinson. Put the that sleep where the knapsack. And it is Reggie in the blunt, don't you pass that. And if I'm bored with the bitch, going past that. And if you talking about greatness, then I'm past that. Life is a film, niggas better cast that. Emblem on my neck, watch my dad about to cast that. Jewelry talk. See me, you see a movie walk. That's Brad Pitt, Johnny Depp, who you want? Gone. Pass like that, we all winners. I'm in my path like that with mall liquor. 40 ounce, pass it back. We all niggas see me in the trap like that with gold slippers. Gold slippers, see me in the trap like that with gold slippers. Come on, you see I'm shining, she shining, everything's gold though. You see my pockets, my stomach is getting gold though. You see my life starting to change, getting more promo. I got the power, no Austin, getting that mojo. We about to change up the game, cause we them all the same. Look at the slippers, Aladdin, no through that carpet, nigga. They say the kid is a savage, I spit retarded, nigga. You see my team play no games, better be cautious, nigga. My feet, Michael Jackson on them, dancing on them. The way I move, got your girl thinking that I'm glancing on her. I get you wetter from the neck up, now I'm damping on them. And we ain't going nowhere, nigga, we camping on them. Grind, grind to the fullest. Gotta go get it, and you gotta go through it. Like the way I spit it, hitting niggas so fluent. Gotta really stack the bread, stack it up. Like I'm Jones, gold slippers, nigga.
Forgive us, cause we know not what we do.
I'm in a war, survival, CC.
section saved me. Section 8 raised me. Food stamps daily. Garbage pail baby. I swear to God hates me. Never concerned with safety. Queens County raised me. Ran around the house foaming at the mouth. Might have had rabies. Roamed around the streets of New York like I'm crazy. From building.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Crazy. That's that FU. God hates me.
Stole all my polos from Macy's. Talking early 90s. Maybe late 80s. We never had gravy. Consignment was timeless. Getting high on my own supply. And then the head guy was like, fuck you. Pay me. Then we learned to chop up the paisley. Pyrex mindset. Powder on my face like I'm working in a bakery. Then I got lazy. Bagged with like 8 keys. Rikers wouldn't take me. Sent me to the state P. Now I'm out and nobody can sedate me. Flyer than a motherfucker. Mental health escapee. Climbed out the window with some sheets tied to drapery. Hit the ground running from the Jakeys. Hit one of my ladies. Apartment up in Baisley. She let me hide out till everything was Patrick Swayze. Stick my toes on the ledge and ask the Lord to take me. And let go of life and try to flow away gracefully.
Fly, babe. Forgive us cause we know not.
Yeah, that's right. Big shout to DJ Quest, baby.
What the fuck to do?
I see you on the check-in.
Flesh, non-educated and you need deep.
Big shout to Mr. Nice Time.
Get a job, but I need the
petty post.
Constant cloud overhead, I know I'm dead. Sold my old soul for some cold regret. Got the cold shoulder from all the hoes I met. And the foes I get all grow opposed to the goals I set. Happy
shout to everybody that's hit me up on the gram.
And I see how I hate demons that broke bread. Meanwhile, they scheme and hope dead. It seems I'm hopeless, my dreams are cold red. Warning me about all the thieves and vultures. But never believed on what so-and-so said. So here I sleep 6 feet deep in a cold bed. Light creeps in, but the casket's closing. Claustrophobic, pent up rage from the stored emotion. Darkness stays when the walls are closed in, but I'm a soldier. Put on my helmet, walk the hood broad shoulder. No one opposed him. Different outlook, often so distorted. Broke down walls that his soul corroded. Still breaks laws cause he knows they're pointless. Clouds gather over his dome so remorseless. Damn, it's torturous.
Father.
Yeah, that's right. Big shout to Mel Smooth, man.
Cause we know
not. Do remember Brooklyn, he gonna be in the story at Blue Lounge performing.
Been trying to stay righteous, but it's been tough really. Uh-huh. They say watching over.
They gonna be debuting that styling.
Cold shoulders, leaders as puppets and we.
Mel Smooth, best I've very own.
Wake up, cats will do anything to cake up. See that reward money, your man is calling to Jacob. Uh-huh. Somebody turn to somebody if someone take a pay cut. Your girl is selling their body if someone got the paper. Shit, so what's the root of it? In God we trust. And I'm not new to this, but truthfully it drive me nuts. How they could use the beauty of truth to this ground of dust. Confusing the youth to the view skewed. Son, it's enough. And I ain't talk to God in a minute. But I got words for him. Like if we made in his image, then how did germs form? Why this cancer eating at my mom's flesh? Why the fuck you make so much pain if this is just a test? Why'd you hate me?
Yeah, you know what it is. Brooklyn, stand up.
Yeah, you just give me the word. Got a couple young shooters that are putting the word. Show me where that pussy live, we gon' pull up his skirt. He's a dead man walking 1 foot in the dirt. Got a loaded AR in a dark charger. I leave him on the side of the road like Jordan Favre. He don't need a doctor.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Mano Uncle Murder favorite for a favor.
Like we was mobsters.
I'm putting the clip in. We Jordan and Pippin. We Kobe and Shaq. Who you want me to clap? Who you want me to rob? I get you as Rollie. I get you as Chain. I know you'll do the same.
Yeah, you just give me the word. Yeah, you just give me the word. Yeah, you just give me the word. Got a couple young shit. Yeah, you just give me the word. Got a couple young shooters that are putting the word. Show me where that pussy live. We gon' pull up his skirt. He's a dead walker, walking foot, foot, dirt, dirt. Got a loaded AR in a shock shot. I leave him on the side of the road like Bob. He don't need a doctor. Call a cop. Get a toast to his death. A smile, smile.
I'm putting the clip in. We Jordan and Pippin. We Kobe and Shaq. Who you want me to clip? I'm putting the clip in. We Jordan and Pippin. We Kobe and Shaq. Who you want me to clip? I'm putting the clip in. I'm putting the clip in. I'm putting the clip in. We Jordan and Pippin. We Kobe and Shaq. Who you want me to clap? Who you want me to rob? I get you as Rollie. I get you as Chain. I know you'll do the same. It's murder in Maine. Rest
rest in peace, you suck. It's murder in May. Rest in peace, you suck. It's murder in May. It's murder in May. It's murder in May. It's murder in May. Rest in peace, you suckers. We got niggas that's with us that'll shoot up the mothers. Shoot at the undercovers. Niggas is with the shits. We got shooters that's bloods. We got shooters that's Chris Crips.
I murder who you want murdered.
How do you have you? Who you bump body?
We bring it to everybody.
I dead dead. Who you want dead?
Who you want dead? Any. I murder who you want murdered.
I body who you want body.
We bring it to anybody.
Who dead? Who you want dead?
I wet. Who you want wedding?
Anybody.
Shooting for shooting, favor for favor. Call me, I run out the crib like I'm your neighbor. Couple blocks down, we dot them with red lasers. In all black, my killers pop out like Darth Vader. Come on, get your body right. Left hand karate chop. For you, dog, I dismantle niggas like it's a body shop. Is you ready to roll? Cause I'm ready to ride. Hold me down in the east, you good in the sky.
You my right hand man, who gotta get left?
Who
gotta get shot?
Who
acting like Pac? Mikasa, Tsukasa, blood in, blood out. I know where he live, bang, bang. When he come out, my brother from another mother, you know how we roll. Get a nigga shot on his way home for parole. We Robert De Niro and Al Pacino. Take orders from each other, we ain't got no ego.
I murder who you want murdered.
I body who you want body.
We bring it to anybody.
I dead who you want dead.
I wet who you want wet.
Anybody can get it.
I murder who you want murdered.
I body who you want body.
We bring it to anybody.
I dead who you want dead.
I wet who you want wet.
See, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat.
I don't understand.
See, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at.
I don't understand.
See, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it. Came from the bottom to the top. Came from the bottom. Came from the bottom. Came from the bottom. From the bottom. From the bottom. From the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, bring the pain, low nigga, low nigga, low nigga, low nigga, low. I don't play, low nigga, you can spray, low nigga, low nigga, low.
Got drama, cause niggas is fucking up commas. Niggas be plotting and scheming.
Yeah, that's right, that's that little nigga. Conan.
Niggas be saying they
cover,
but I never seen it.
See ya.
All I hear is snitches talking to judges like, listen, your honor. Niggas smoking that loud. Smoking that. Me, I believe. Niggas will shoot up your crib. Make sure you're dead. They shoot up your coffin.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. We got FU in the building.
Cars, hoes, and drugs. And niggas be getting that often.
We got a great interview online. We got FU, E Sinatra, Facts on Wax. Miss Too Real herself.
I'm after that money, my vision on coke. I'm bagging your bitch, my dick in her throat. I'm gunning them down, my eye in the scope.
Hey, see, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat. Whoa. I'm with the gang, low nigga, bring the pain, low nigga, low nigga, low nigga, low. I don't play low, nigga, you can spray low, nigga, low, nigga, low. I'm the hottest and you know that. How they came to paint a picture like it's Kodak. Really like to eat, so the pockets would be so fat. Alpha be on fleek to the sneaks to my dome hat. I'ma be like, hold that, bobbing with the bros. If you bought it, then I bought it, cause we got it for the low. Gotta pay the king first before we pass through the toes. Before you step on my crown, gotta ask for the gold. Whoa, I do this for the love, but I don't have to. Had the keys to the city, not the bathroom. Shorty wanna tour, yeah, for sure, call shampoo. I be with your slow first for Lord, but I ran through. Whoa, I be in the Benz all tenant. Fuck bitches, get money, you can cover it all in it. Call up my nigga, cover, have it, seat you in a minute. Sending records my way, New York, let's get it. Hey, 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 hey. See, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat. Whoa. I'm with the gang, low nigga, bring the pain, low nigga, low nigga, low.
Whoa.
I don't play, low nigga, you can spray, low nigga, low nigga, low. Hey, hey, hey. See, I came from the bottom to the top, so now I'm in it at. Whoa. See, I'm from New York, low nigga, you can stomp till you fit a cat. Whoa,
whoa.
I'm with the gang, low nigga, bring the gang, low nigga, low nigga, low nigga.
No, it is.
I don't play, low nigga, you can spray low, spray low, spray low, spray low.
Hey, yo, what's poppin', Vandals? It's your motherfucking boy, Facts on Wax. I'm back in the motherfucking building. Now, check it out. Tonight on a Vandalize, we have a real spitter in the motherfucking building, a lyricist. He is a part of the Broken Home family, and he goes by the name of F.U.
Yo, what's good, Vandalo?
It's poppin', how you feeling tonight?
What's poppin', man? I'm feeling glorious, man. I'm feeling like a fucking brand new piece of jewelry, man. How you?
There you go. Peace, man. Appreciate you coming out, showing us some love, man.
Appreciate y'all having me.
Word.
For the people that might not be familiar with your music, give the viewers a little background on you and what you do.
My name is F.U., man, and I rap. I write rap music. And then I record it in the studio, and then I put it out, and people listen to it, and some people pay for it. You know what I'm saying? That's what I do.
There you go.
But I've been here for a minute, man. I'm from New York. You know what I'm saying? I grew up in New York my whole life. You know, been around graph my whole entire life. You know what I'm saying? Been around hip hop my whole life. So I've been out in these streets, man. I just started rapping in like 2011. Really.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Before that, it was like bullshit. Like, yo, freestyling with my friends.
Just something you did.
You know, it's just something I did. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I'm still a knucklehead and shit, still out in the streets, getting locked up, just down the third. Mm-hmm. And I had forgotten. I'm like, yo, I'm not even going to rap no more, man. Rap is whack. I was just spinning records and DJing and shit for my friends. And it really took my brother Spit Gems to pull me out. Like, I just spit something for him. And he was like, yo, my dude, you got to start spitting, man. Stop fucking around, man. You better than a lot of these niggas out here and shit. So
That's how it went. Since 01, you've been going hard with it.
Nah, since 2011.
Oh, 11. My bad. 2011. And shout out to Spit Gems.
Yo, Spit Gems was up here, too. So I know the things he doing on mic. I'm pretty sure you and him in the same caliber of fucking up microphones.
He crushes motherfuckers, though, man. He's like my favorite MC, though, right now.
And shout out to Spit Gems, man. Definitely puts in work.
Curious.
Uh-huh.
The name F.U., how did that come about?
Yo, when I was like 18 years old, I would go to open mics just to fuck around, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't have a rap name because I didn't rap, but I didn't want to put my real name out there, so I would put funny names on the lists, you know what I'm saying? I had a list. So I'd be like, yo, what can I make the host say that's fucking hilarious?
Yeah.
So I'd put like Senator Dukakis. It's like stupid shit, you know what I'm saying? To have them say. And then one time I came up with F.U.
This nigga said Senator Dukakis.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what can I say that would be funny?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, yo, it'd be funny to make the host say F.U. to the crowd and shit.
I hear you.
I did. The host happened to be C-Ray's Walls.
Okay.
And I went on stage and I spit some shit. I got off stage and C-Ray's came up to me. He's like, yo, that name is dope, son. Like, you got it. That's your name. And from then on, I was like,
F.U.
There it is, F.U. I was going to change it to just straight fuck you, but then I'm like, I'll just never get play anywhere. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
You're smart.
You know what I'm saying? Let me just make it F.U. So.
I mean, F.U. get the point across.
Exactly. Now,
do you consider yourself an underground MC?
I consider myself a lyricist, man. I consider myself an artist. Whoever puts me in whatever category they want to at the time, then so be it. You know what I'm saying? I make the music that I make right now, but the music that I'm making in 93 would not have been considered underground music. You know what I'm saying? It would have been considered, I guess, mainstream hip hop. But now it's considered underground music. But 30 years from now,
absolutely,
it might be considered classical music. You know what I'm saying? So whatever genre they, you know, the people who put people in genres, if they want to put me in the underground category, then so be it. I'm fine with it. But myself, I consider myself an artist. You know what I'm saying?
Let me ask you this: do you do all types of music? Are you into the trap? Are you into is there things you stay away from when it comes to music?
As far as what I do or what I like,
what you like?
I like all kinds of music, man. I grew up. I'm Peruvian. I was born in Peru, so I grew up listening to salsa. You know what I'm saying? Merengue, bachata, all that stuff was in my home. And you know, classic rock, soul music. You know what I'm saying? And hip-hop, obviously, rock, all that shit. I listen to everything. Anything that's good, anything that has mind-provoking lyrics in it, I'll listen to it.
I mean, I should ask, if people, you know, you have friends around you, who is somebody you listen to that maybe us or maybe your friends would never imagine that?
I drive down Myrtle Avenue, man, with the windows down playing Johnny Cash all the fucking time, man. And people looking at me funny. For many reasons,
yeah.
But Y'all don't give a fuck, man. Yeah, yo, Johnny right. Cash is dope.
Yeah,
I don't
care what you know the history think, on G. that
Johnny,
man right
Johnny
there.
Johnny Cash is ill. I blast Johnny Cash. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I fucks with him when I'm out to get cash. I'm just like Johnny. Yo.
Yo, Sus lyrics was nasty, son.
Of
Yo.
Course. He talked.
He talked that
back
realness.
Then when talk, nobody was what? Talking like that.
Come on, man.
Johnny Cash, do the homework, y'all.
I took a shot of cocaine and I shot my woman down. That's yeah. a Johnny Cash line.
There you go. There you go.
Yo, I had a nigga pop up on me today like, yo, Facts or Wax, what's popping? And the nigga just started sniffing mad coke. Really? But, <What? laughs> yo, should be happening. Right now, who do you feel is holding it down for the lyricists besides you spitting Shaz?
For the lyricists, man, yo, there's a lot of lyricists out there, man. You know, New York is booming right now. Anybody in New York, my homie Starvin' B, you know, yeah. Mayhem Loren.
Yeah.
We just talking about Nems Gutter.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They're really holding it down. My homie Mitchell Ames. Outside of New York, I mean, it's tough to say. I listen to a lot of West Side Gun, Conway. They're killing it right now. I listen to Royce the 5'9 and the whole Slaughterhouse crew.
Beast.
Yeah, Beast. You know what I'm saying? They're holding it down heavy.
Yo, who's a lyricist that you might feel that's underrated that nobody knows about?
Right now?
Right now, that you think is hard body with it.
Yo, for real, man, I don't think that my man GS Advance gets enough shine and respect, man. Dude is an evil genius, man.
Okay.
GS Advance is, I suggest if you don't know who he is that you type in GS Advance into your home screen.
And go check that out.
Go check that out, man. He's a very slept on list. And Starvin' B, too, man. Starvin' B is one of my favorite MCs, too.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think he's slept on, but, I mean, you know, more people should know about him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They going to learn tonight.
As far as those names, Starvin' B and a few of the guys, have you done music with these guys yourself?
Oh, yeah, definitely, man. We all linked up at Goblin Studios. Shout to Goblin. Shout to Spent De Niro. Out by Queensbridge, out in Long Island City. And it was just such an atmosphere there, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like Starvin' B would be there rapping, Gems, me, I'd be there rapping. Sean Price would pop up and start a cypher, you know what I'm saying? Psycho Lesson Juju. The atmosphere was so crazy. You know what I mean?
Strong
and
atmosphere
that's
what right
yeah, that's why I met a lot of the guys that I know now, you know what I mean? It was through there, and this was 2010, 2011, and that's another reason why I was brought back into spitting. You know, I was around such amazing spitters. You know what
motivation.
I mean? It was motivation. And being there, your sword had to be sharp. Mm, you couldn't absolutely. Come there and spit some garbage shit because you get clowned on quick.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That's the wrong place to not come there with your shit correct.
Exactly.
Let me ask you this: being a lyricist yourself, and I mean that a lyricist. Do you think that not even the game or just in general, do people respect the lyricists in 2016?
You know, that's hard to say, man. I feel there's been a real, and I don't want to get too technical and too, you know, conspiracy theorists about
you
it.
Can.
There's,
you can.
There's
if you
been
want
a real there's been a real dumbing down of the United States by the media. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, they because it's easier to control a dumber society. You know what I mean? And, I think it's worked in a lot of situations, because a lot of people think the easier it is to understand, you know, the funner it'll be, the doper it'll be, the more attention it gets, etc. So, but I definitely see a resurgence of lyricists coming up. You know what I mean? Like that that Pusha T Jay-Z track. Yo, that shit was ill.
Yeah.
It was ill on so many levels. You know what I'm saying? Had the ill beat, it got play. Pusha T's verse was fucking stupendous.
Hard.
You know what I'm saying? It was hard body. And it was very lyrical to me.
Yes.
So it's I definitely see a resurgence of it. But lately, yeah, maybe he's been lacking as far as respect is concerned.
What's the name of that track you're talking about?
Anonymous Drug Dealers,
drug
I think?
Drug Dealers. Yeah.
Right,
Drug Dealers Anonymous or Anonymous Drug Dealers?
Drug Dealers Anonymous.
Okay, there it goes.
I'm going to check that out tonight.
Oh, you haven't heard that yet?
Nah, that's why I just asked you what the fuck is called.
That's just fire.
Facts on Wax was under a rock last night.
Well, yeah, you know, this guy does a lot of
yo,
things.
Yo, I'm a busy person. Like, besides sitting up here talking on this mic, like, I really do a whole lot of activities. Yo.
Just got that and played it all.
My G. F.U., you said,
top
right?
Song.
You was born in Peru and shit, right?
I was.
Yo.
Do you feel that gives you a different outlook and perspective when you in that booth and your approach to hip hop?
Definitely, man. I mean, look, a lot of people come from third world countries, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people come from the slums here in New York. Like, when I moved from Peru to here, you know, I lived in slums. And when I moved there, it was in 85. Everything was a slum. Bushwick was a slum, my nigga. I mean, it was empty fucking buildings everywhere, rubble. Yes. I'm talking about it was a war zone.
That's true.
So I was coming from a war zone into a war zone. You know what I mean? So that definitely shaped me differently.
How old were you when you came over here from
Peru? I was five.
Was there a hip-hop scene out there in Peru?
Definitely not.
And you can remember back then?
Yeah, because there wasn't a hip-hop scene in New York, too. I mean, in Peru. I would think the first real hip-hop that they listened to was, like, Eminem. You know what I'm saying? Before that,
okay, hear what
they
you're
really
saying.
Didn't. They didn't
it
really,
wasn't something that was going
nah,
on over there.
Not at all.
It was just like you said, clicking on this side. Well, not just clicking, but getting to that point. Being from Peru and having that background, the roots in your background, have you been back since? Would you go back to Peru to do music?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Now, I mean, look, now I'm popping out there. Now, because, you know, I'm from there. So, you know what I'm saying? I would
not
definitely
too many
go
artists
back.
I hear come from there, and that's why I ask.
As from what I know, it's Immortal Technique myself, and I think there was another MC that I know, you know what I'm saying, that was introduced to me. So yeah, I'll definitely go back. I know Thurston's been out there. Okay. He's done shows out there. I would love for them to bring me out there, man. You know what I mean? It takes bread, man.
Absolutely.
It takes bread.
We definitely gotta get FU out there back to the hometown, man. Do a nice little show out there.
If Peru's listening, because we're on the internet, so yes, anybody can be listening.
Yes.
Fucking get me out there,
yo,
man.
You never saying? Know what could happen with that new New York tour. State facts. We going places. Fuck with us before that price go up.
I would definitely wouldn't mind taking a stop out there to Peru and to check out FUN and a couple other things that's going on.
I've been out there, man. The funny
thing,
you
want to see.
The funny thing about you know, going back there was I started getting into this low shit in the 90s.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I was a preteen, like 13 years old. When I was 13, I figured out, oh shit, I can go into Macy's and steal this shirt and nothing will happen to me. Like, they might call my parents, they might let me go. But like 90% of the time, I'm not going to get caught. So that's when I was like, I just started racking clothes, you know what I'm saying? Then when I got older, I see pictures of my cousins in Peru. And mind you, they're poor. Like, they make $20 a month type poor. But they're rocking low sweaters, man. P-wings and fucking flosh. Oh, and I'm telling my mom, like, yo, how did they get this shit out there? Oh, Bobby, you wasn't using this, so I sent it out there. Yeah, so I'm like, at the time, I was tight, but now I'm kind
of
happy.
Of course,
you know,
of course.
They was out there rocking fly shit, and nobody even knew.
You heard the room. Like, the pain was felt throughout the room.
I had so many pieces, though. But now, like, now this shit is on eBay for $1,000.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? But
yes.
Back then, it was nothing. I was just like, yeah, fuck it. Let them have it. You know what I mean? Let them look fly out there.
Are you still into the low thing? Are you still?
Oh, yeah, definitely, man. I'm going to a Low Life Barbecue on the 24th of this month, actually.
All right, okay. I'm in there, too, then.
Yeah,
shout out to them.
Where's taking place at?
It's in the park, man. What the fuck is his name, man?
Well, listen, if we can't get it now, we'll definitely make sure we plug it before we go
Yo,
off.
And don't embarrass yourself by fucking going to this barbecue wearing some USPA.
This shit might get stripped.
A nigga
you definitely
you, kick you on your ass and stomp you off for doing that one.
Don't try to do that shit.
Hey, yo, F.
Yo.
Hip-hop has changed drastically in the past few years. Do you feel you can stand with the major changes happening in hip-hop?
I mean, yeah, definitely, man. Look, hip-hop to me has always been about having fun. You know what I'm saying? It's always been about fun. The lyricism comes because that just happens to be what comes out when I start writing. But I always like to have fun. You know what I mean? On every record I make, every mixtape or album, I try to add some fun songs into it. You know what I mean? I got a song I'm writing now called Tons of Fun with Buns and Guns. You know what I mean? It's over a trap beat, but I'm still spitting some lyrical shit. You know what I mean? So I can definitely keep up with the times. It's about if the times is going to catch up to me.
Catch
you know what
up.
I'm saying?
I hear that. Now, right now, for some people who this is their first time hearing of FU, is there somewhere they can go now to listen to some of the music, like SoundCloud or?
Right now, You can go any. If you go to Google, type my name in, EFFYOO. All my pages are gonna pop up. I'm on SoundCloud. I'm on Bandcamp. I just dropped an album called The F Word. You go on iTunes and type in The F Word.
Check
type
that
in
out.
FU. And my songs will come up. You know what I mean? Go on YouTube, type in FU. I got tons of video, tons of shit out there.
Oh, visuals too.
Definitely.
Oh, of course. My favorite part of the game. Let me ask you this. You said 2011, 16, about 5 years now you in the game.
Yeah.
What do you think is one of the major things that you learned about the rap game in those 5 years?
Oh, man. To be honest, one of the major things is that you got to move with a team. And what I mean by move with a team is not like five lyricists, you know what I mean? Like Broken Home, we five lyricists. We eight lyricists actually now. But I mean move with a team. Like you got to have somebody who knows the social media game. You know what I'm saying? You got to have somebody who is nice with the mixing and mastering, yes, the beats. You got to have the videographer
that's
on
a team.
Deck. You know what I'm saying? That's the team. You got to build a strong team and move with that team. If you think you're going to come out here and just earn off of your prowess and just on your lyrics, it's not gonna work for you, man.
Too much for one man to do. And,
yeah,
and it's true. I feel like if you're gonna anything you do outside of music as well,
right,
if you any type of business, try to have somebody or the people around you that are not only just worth something, but they're good at what they do.
Right.
So if you are a beat maker or you're a producer, make sure that that's what they do and they're good at it.
Yeah.
And that shit will increase your chances of hopefully being successful.
Yeah, definitely.
Right now, is there something about the rap or hip hop game that you don't like? Something that just be like, you know what? I wish this didn't happen.
The one thing I can say is just terrestrial radio. You know what I'm saying? The way they set up the songs that get play and don't get play is really whack to me. You know what I'm saying? Back in the days, you know, your top 10 would consist of Heavy D and Poor Righteous Teachers. You know what I'm saying? At the same time, everybody building together and be different kind of songs. It'd be a conscious hip-hop song, a party hip-hop song.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? A street hip-hop song all in the same radio station. Now, it's been said. Yo, if you're not popping in the clubs, you're not getting radio play. And that's one type of hip-hop, no doubt. But it's not the only type of hip hop. So that's kind of like I feel like that's kind of whack to me. It's not a proper representation of
what's going on out in the world. You're right. I mean, we hear that a lot about New York radio stations,
yeah,
especially.
Word.
You know, they get a lot of heat for. We were speaking in the cab on the way over here. Our intern, new intern was in the building. He came over to the show with me, and I was explaining to him before the internet. You know, like not only DJs played such a major part in the music because they the ones who broke the record. Yeah. You know, before you had all these sites where you can click and it was waiting for your favorite DJ on your favorite station to break your favorite artist's new record. You know, and it took, that's one of the things. If I could take it back, Swift, I know you would love this, is to get the DJs more involved. Because, you know, and not that it's going anywhere, but I remember I caught a little piece of that. I'm not that old, but I caught a little piece of that when the internet wasn't just major and you had to log into your or listen into your favorite radio station, your favorite DJ, and to know, you know, my new artist. If FU was back then, we'd be like, oh, FU got a new track. Flex or whoever it was, Clue back then was going crazy with the new artist. And that's one thing I would change about the game, you know what I mean?
And back then, they could spin who they wanted to spin.
Yes. Like
basically, now they spin
about
what
who
they're
got
told.
Them big pockets.
Yes.
Right. They spin
more
what they're told to play. You know what I'm saying? I know for a fact that
Payola, baby.
DJs out there have gotten in trouble for playing records that they were not supposed to play.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So that's kind of whack.
Check this out. We're going to take a quick music break. And when we come back, we're going to finish chopping it up with a few state facts.
Let's
I will never lie to you. Ayo Swift, do what the fuck you do.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Starving B. Swedenborg, Eye of the Storm.
What up, Fell Swedenborg? Sometimes it's right to be Society don't want a part of me. They probably hope I split a major artery. It takes a certain eye to find the art in me. I'm partially a cynic. My evil is optimistic. Lines doper than the ones you find in methadone clinics at the end. What the fuck does it all amount to? I'm getting numbers, chasing numbers that I couldn't count to. Society don't want. And it's like the paper's burning in my face. Only thing that ever changed is love turning into hate. Gotta learn from the mistakes while I savor every breath. Translate the flavor, feel it oscillating in your chest. I go ahead and make a mess because I know how to clean it up. Once I get you on the ledge, you gon' hear me screaming, jump, jump. Big bumps from the car trunk, is that what you want? The fist pump came after my first blunt. Humble as a pie, but I'm sure of my shit. 86 feet high with the furious fist. Now let the record show the dedication, cause every second is a celebration. Make it feel similar to levitation. I say sometimes it's right to be wrong. When you're walking through the eye of the storm, tell them some more. It's hard to survive with money signs over your eyes. I know these corporations hoping that my culture is blind. These wise guys try to fill a cigar box. The real shit pops, the honest man to be the certified hard rock. How do you do with your street IQ? So-called MCs selling weak haikus. Next word of all the weed I move. Got a lifetime supply of fire. Put
my forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got you ducking down quick like I was repping Helter Skelter. Hellfire rock bell, I still got you figuring. Civil tense can't handle the belligerence I'm giving them. Forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got your forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got my forces like Delta, forces like Delta, better forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got you ducking down quick like I was repping Helter Skelter. Hellfire rock bell, I still got you figuring. Civil tense can't handle the belligerence I'm.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Starving B. Everybody shining.
Yeah.
Featuring Shaz Il York, Spit Gems. Let's
my
go.
My forces like Delta, better wrong for your shelter. Got you ducking down quick like I was repping Helter Skelter. Hellfire rock bell, I still got you figuring. Civil tense can't handle the belligerence I'm giving them. Sickening, sticking with the sickles, then I'm ripping them. Jigsaw to grill at will, I'm disfiguring. The actual, shrouded in shadows, composed of masterful. Bastard with a father, you're on a label, me classical. I do so, maintain the kick of a desert. Whatever, however you want it, pirate your treasure. When it's seen, it came back, now brace yourself for the impact. Like hitting wall speeding in a Japanese compact. No airbags to save you, the raider. Me and your maker all purpled up like you was playing for the Lakers. Vote from Gotham. Another modern day Saddam with sacrifices go down like Diana hitting the columns. 13 fight on these beats like the Burmese. Equivalent to no one, so none of y'all concern me. Turnkey opening the door to the truth. Fuck a public school, they'll tell stories like mother.
Everybody was shining. It's like most of them ain't shit now. My shit knocking like it's somebody in the trunk trying to get out. Breathe ease on me, please. Watch what you spit out.
I can see the
fucking hit out. So now, cop a couple copies of my shop, so much copies of my shop, so much copies
of my shop. All that. I can see myself getting a lot.
Yeah, that's right. That's that Dave East 9. Forbes list.
I can see the condo. Miami.
I can see me in a sports car on 16th, shots of brown at the sports bar. At 16, I was hiding report cards. Now I see myself getting wet.
Yeah, that's right. Stay tuned. We got more with FU.
Got the directions. Monday night, hit the strip joint and cop a section. Niggas ain't fighting no more. We got some weapons. Do it for the culture. I really come from the essence. Essence magazine, brown skin. Cousin from the Heights, she told me he got some pounds in. City out in Brooklyn, he be back uptown around 10. Mad traffic in the crib, going through it with housing. If I get evicted, play my bitch crib. You don't want no drama, niggas pop up where your kids live. Set up where your wife work. I be dressed like I'm just coming, see if your lights work. Shoot it.
Yeah, that's right. Stay tuned, stay tuned.
Light work. I see.
We got FU still in the building.
Smoke. I see me getting low if you gotta go.
Kill him.
I see me in that foreign. See me with that Gucci umbrella when it's pouring. That's how I see it. I see me with connects from the motherland. Backwood in my left, pistol in my other hand. I see me on the Forbes list, see me in them Porsches, still rocking all white Forbes.
I rock tuxes, busters, clusters cover my watches, drop mustard color, father cars have been Rogers. Only queens I fuck with, Celine clutches, my bitch, bullet holes to my foes.
Once again, we got Miss Two Real in the building.
Green Nikes, they don't like me.
Shea Peters.
Cuffing they lady when they sight me. Back with blowing, yak be poin', it's nothing. I'm rap, Benjamin Button, Nasty Don, Rich Millie on the arm. Been literally rich since 9-6, still where to hit my enemies with a tech at 9-6. Exotic materials on the neck and fly whips. I was fresh out the jacks, decked out the depth. Y'all witnessed it, I can fill you with real millionaire shit. Cargo, front lawn like a dealership. Who I rep? 10th Street, 12th Street, plus the Vernon family. And that's where the yam word. You see me in that ghost with a lot of smoke.
See it.
I see me getting low if you gotta go.
See it.
You see me in my foreign. See me with that Margiela umbrella when it's pouring. That's how I see it. I see me with connects from the motherland. Wood in the left, cash in my other hand. See, I'm truer than the Forbes list. See me in the Porsche, still rocking them 84 Jordans.
See me in Dubai, me and Buddha high. Buddha. Moving pies, I still see his mother through the sky. I see tan lines, models, haters be anti. I was smoking gram dimes, playing Foster with franchise. I see myself in that GQ magazine. I was low, nobody in the streets knew I had a fiend. He had a green Honda Civic, parked it on my block. I could drive it for days, just made sure he had a rock. Waking up, smoking Kush, I could see the envy. Weed and Henny, that's the reason it's evil in me. I want it all, I ain't letting them keep a penny. I see me slumped in that Bentley, bumping the best of Biggie. Shouts to Philly, I see me and Freaky laughing. I see nothing in the Porsche, I see Lil in the Aston. I can see the city from a penthouse view. Married to the streets, the avenue just said I do. I see me in that ghost with a lot of smoke. See it. I see me getting low if you gotta go. See it. I see me in that foreign. See me with that Gucci umbrella when it's pouring. That's how I see it. Gucci. I see me with connects from the motherland. Backwood in my left, pistol in my other hand. I see me on the Forbes list. I see me in the Porsches. Still rocking old white.
Hey, yo, Alfie, what's poppin'? How you feeling?
Yo, I'm feeling fucking vainglorious, man.
Yo, I got something I want to ask you.
What up?
What major changes is FU making to the hip-hop culture?
What I'm making, listen, what I try to do, man, I think about my lyrics. You know what I'm saying? I put thought into every single thing I say, into every single thing I do. You know, I think that's lacking right now. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely missing. My whole team moves like that. You know what I'm saying? And that's what we're trying to bring to the table. But also, I'm expanding, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm building a brand here. You know what I'm saying? FU is not just FU the rapper. You know what I'm saying? I have a web series called Don't Be a Piece of Shit Your Whole Life. Oh. And basically, I just it's like a how-to, you know? Teach you how to tie a tie, how to properly cut and light a cigar. You know what I'm saying? How to do different things. How to be an adult male. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, let me tell you this. When you said the title, I was not thinking that's what it was going to be. So you threw me off right there.
Yeah.
And not that I was shocked. I was. That's a dope move
that
right
is
there.
So dope.
It's a how-to. You know, how to not be a piece of shit your whole life.
I would definitely be checking that out.
Well, yeah, I'll just on YouTube. Just type that in. It's got a fourth episode's coming out soon. I got three out now.
Okay, dope. I'll definitely check that out, man.
Yeah.
Production-wise, producer-wise,
right.
Who have you worked with and who would you like to work with?
My first mixtape was produced by my homie Golden Child. He's got a studio out here in Brooklyn, man. Peace to him. This new album was produced entirely by Ridiculous. He's a producer out of Chicago.
Okay.
Definitely shout out to him. But I've worked with, a bunch of different Queens producers, Don Peducci. Shout out to Stu Bangers, definitely. I'd like to get some work with Harry Fraud in, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I'd like to get something from Domingo. Definitely the homie Juju and Psycho Less, you know, they produce too. I would love to get something from them, Large Pro. I'd definitely like to jump in. There's a group called F Dope out of Staten Island. I'd like to get some beats from them, you know what I'm saying? And jump into a new sound, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to keep it all underground boom bap beats.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
I like
forever,
that.
You know what
I like
mean?
That. A little bit of sun, a little bit of everything. A
little bit of everything, man. A dream. I'd love to get some MF Doom beats, man, in my catalog.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? Something from Primo.
Now, as far as we got the producers out the way. Is there somebody that you say, you know, I really wish I could lay down a track just me and?
Really. I'd have to say Slick Rick, man.
Ooh.
And I don't know if that's like a cliche answer because he's an old school MC, but I think he's a very slept on old school MC, man. When people talk about the GOATs, you know, definitely Rakim.
They definitely forget his name.
Kane is up there, you know, Kool G Rap. And I love them too, don't get me wrong. But Slick Rick is nasty, son. I wish I could get him on
that
a track,
would be dope
man.
To get
if
him.
I get him on some pimp shit, man, oh, man, that'd be a dream collab.
That would be dope. F you imagine what the title would say. Whatever the song would be named, it would be F U ahead. That like it, if you had to think real quick, what would be a song, a quick title? If they gave you a call like Slick Rick's ready to do the track. He needs a title for the track.
If Slick Rick wanted to do a track, man, I don't know, man. I think I'd call it Silk Shirts and Fast Hands.
Ooh. I like that. Listen, man. We are Graffiti Hip Hop Show.
Yes.
You are an MC.
Righteous.
So this is the part where we're gonna let FU do his thing. Tell your friend to tell a friend, y'all. I don't know. Listen,
get them TDKs ready.
We can do this either way. We can drop the beat, let you go off a cappella. We can give you a beat if you like.
Yeah.
It's up to you, FU.
Yeah, let me just work without the beat, man.
That's
let me,
cool.
Let me
That's
think
cool.
of something.
Swift? Yeah, just go hold that beat down real quick.
Yeah.
Lower it all the way down.
I don't know.
All right, listen, y'all. It's the Vandal Hour live on DTFRadio.com. Right now we have FU in the building. I'm going to let the man do his thing. Pay attention. Tell a friend to tell a friend, y'all.
Yeah. We're making history.
Sitting at the top of a totem, flipping poems, pen a magnum opus, deeper than the open ocean. Leave your girl wide open, shaking and moaning. Every morning, cook poached orca while we smoke a potion. Past the bong, I'm up in Valhalla trying to domesticate a mastodon, cracking lobster claws and prawns, and prey upon pawns, and turn them into fertilizer, spray up my lawn. My feet are firmly planted on the firmament, a permanent reminder to my earth of what my birth father's sperm had did. Amazing girth, murdering cervixes, and serve as an ambassador to nerds and shit. I search the multiverse trying to verse the best version of me and merge with him as he begs for mercy under my feet. I'm the teacher of the teacher that had taught Bruce Lee facial features that'll make a model's mom lose sleep. It's me.
Ooh.
Yeah. Thank you.
That was FU, y'all, live on the Vandal Hour on DTFRadio.com. And like you heard the man before, if you want to listen to any more music, you can just Google up the name. He's on most of your music, social media sites.
You got to type it in right, though. A lot of yes, people type it's E-F-F-Y-O-O. That's how you spell my name. F-U, phonetically spell that out. You know what I mean? You got to know what you're doing if you're going to search for me.
All right. No, I was getting this question, and I was supposed to ask you this before. Politics. All
right. Yeah.
Politics. Real quick before we get to the end of this. A lot of stuff going on in that game. I know it's crazy. Hillary and Trump are the lead runners right
now. Yes, yes.
Do you vote? Are you voting? And do you even care about that kind of stuff?
They're both reptiles. Mm. So, you know, I believe they're both reptilians. Spawned from the same alien race, but nah, man, I really think the choice is out of our hands, to be 1,000% honest with you.
Mm-hmm. Agree.
They gonna do what they do.
Let me tell you, if the choice was in our hands, man, what fucking choice do we have? Hillary or Trump? Like,
yeah, that's the choices.
We have two non-politicians running for president right now. This is insane. This is insanity. Right. So. It's really out of our hands, man. They chose those nominees for us, and they're going to choose the president for us.
I'm sorry. Who's they?
They. You know DJ Khaled's they.
They.
Them. They don't want you to have a pool like Kanye.
They are going to give you these two choices right here. Hillary and...
They. The Bilderberg Group all those reptilians already chose for you.
I see. You're my kind of guy. We read the same kind of things.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up. You know what? We're definitely going to have you come back sooner or later. We're going to definitely have to chop it up on that note.
Whatever you want to talk about,
man. You sound like you got a little bit of info or everything, right?
I try to stay knowledgeable about everything, man. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I put so many things into my lyrics, and I want to know about all those things. I never want to be called out or questioned about something I spit and not know what the fuck I'm talking about.
Deep.
Yo, F, when you said that, though, what did this mean? I can break down any single bar I've ever spit to you. And if I don't know it, I'm going to look it up. Before I put it out, I might write it down, but if I don't know what it means, I'm looking it up. I'm doing my history I put it out.
Putting in that work. And real quick, we spoke about the correct spelling, which is?
It's E F F Y O O. It's the phonetic spelling of F U. You don't know what a phonetic spelling is? I don't even want you to listen to my music. You're going to get fucking lost.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
So listen, y'all. If y'all Google it up and y'all want to look it up, it's E F F Y O
O.
Oh,
righteous.
All
right. F-U, what's popping? Any last words or shout outs you want to give to the peoples?
Yo, I want to shout out Broken Home, man. I want to shout out everybody in Broken Home. I want to shout out my wife, Lissette, my daughter, Serene. They're probably not listening right now. They're probably asleep, but I love y'all anyway. Anybody who's ever supported me, man, thank you. If you've ever spent any amount of money to buy the fucking dumb shit that I say, I appreciate you. Thank you very much, man. And everybody who's helped me grow throughout the years, man. Thank y'all. Misery, what up, man? Thank you.
Peace.
Thank y'all for having me, too.
And definitely.
Thank you for coming through.
Exactly. And thank you for coming through and showing us some love here on the Vandal Hour, man. Real quick, y'all, we wanted to give a shout-out to also our first guest.
Reeps Rock was popping.
Exactly. Shout out to him for coming through the Vandal Hour and showing us some love. And of course, our co-host for coming through. A lot of things going on with her. You're going to see her on DTF Radio very, very soon. Shout out to Sha. Do we know when the radio station starting?
The middle of July.
Ooh, right around the corner.
Either the 13th or the Wednesday after that.
All right, man. Listen, make sure she is welcome. First off, welcome to the DTF family.
Thank you.
You know, let's start off with that. And appreciate you for coming out and showing us some love here. And you definitely have our support here from the Vandal Hour and everything you do. So big shout out to you. Is there any shout out to anything you want to say?
Shout out to the Money and Violence family, you know. They gave me the platform to actually, you know, do everything that I'm doing now. I always know where I wanted to be. I just didn't know how I was going to get there. And Money and Violence was definitely the tool that put me where I am now. And shout outs to all of my supporters. I love you all dearly. Shout outs to my mom. They always say you are your worst critic. She's actually my worst critic. She keeps me on my toes.
Cool.
And shout outs to the Vandal Hour for having me
appreciate
here.
That.
I appreciate you guys.
Appreciate that.
I'm a huge supporter now. You guys taught me a lot today.
Thank you for coming out.
God, of course.
Of course, always.
And follow
Which
me.
Which one, the one upstairs or the rat god?
upstairs.
Of course. And make sure you go follow her on IG and also the organization she has going on.
Yes.
Two Real Tea.
Two Real's Tea Party.
There you go. And make sure you support, y'all.
And on Instagram, I'm Two Real. T-O-O-R-E-A-L.
Yo, fellas, before I get off this, I want to say one thing. Yo, if you're going to pop up in a girl's DM box, send her a duck, not a dick pic. They like ducks.
And listen, man. And always, of course, a big shout out to Mark, Mark DTF. And DTF Radio for always holding us down. Shout out to the whole Vandal Hour family. A lot of stuff goes on behind the scenes to make all this happen that a lot of you guys don't get to see. So shout out to everybody who makes it happen. And of course, the biggest shout out always goes out to our listeners, our viewers, our followers who support us on social media and everywhere else. Shout out to y'all. Without y'all, none of this would happen and it would be able to go down. So shout out to y'all. And of course, man, listen, that's Facts on Wax.
You already know.
You know that is.
The homie Sense said to tell y'all, what's poppin', DTF Radio? We making history. 2016, it's going to get ugly. 17, it's going to get even uglier. I state facts.
Yo, before y'all go, man, I know y'all, you know, y'all talk about graph and shit. I know so many writers, so I don't want to cut anybody out. So I'm not going to mention a lot of people. I'm just going to mention family, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Shout out to the homie Cram One. Shout out to Alski. Noah, what's good, man? Dio. Thank y'all, man. Thank y'all for everything. That's the fam right there. So, and all everybody else that I know, man, I can't mention all y'all motherfuckers.
Yeah, It's a lot of y'all.
It's
shout out to Alski, man.
That's a homie right there.
Listen, I'm Sinatra. That's Facts on Wax. DJ Swift. Drake Hill's on the camera. Shout out to our new intern. Gio's in the building. You know what it is, y'all. Next Saturday, 11 p.m. sharp. Peace.
We turning up.